can to finish it. I want to be the first one to finish Diego. Koscheck was the first to beat him. I want to be the first to finish him.
It's going to be nonstop, and I'm going to be in his face. And it will be an explosion, because I'm not stopping. I'm coming, and I ain't taking my foot off the gas.
The way that we are both tough, we both have chins, we're both willing to throw. I think this fight could be very exciting and could be one of the best fights people have ever seen.
I predict this fight to end in the first round, either submission, ref stoppage, or knockout, any one of the three.
Shogun comes right out every fight, gets right in your teeth, tries to push you back, and tries to beat you up. That's kind of what I want to do to him. So I think it's got to be a good fight.
Voski,
I think he's a good fighter. I respect him. I like the fact that he's a well-known fighter here. This is my first fight here in America. It's going to be a high-profile fight, and I expect to give the best for the fans.
Of course he's going to bring the best out of me, you know? I'm excited about it right now. I'm excited about training for this fight. I'm excited about fighting one of the best guys in the world, you know? And I like my chances.
Well, of course, winning is important, but it is also important to me to have a convincing victory, to show the promoters, the fans, that I have what it takes to take the belt.
He can't afford to lose to me. He just lost his last fight, and if he loses to me, then he's going to have to rethink his career and figure out where he's going to go. So I know he's hungry. I know he's training harder than ever, and I'm ready for that.
If he stays standing, it's going to be an exciting fight until he falls down.
I'm a fighter. I'm in this fight to win this fight. I'm here to beat up Chuck Liddell.
He's going to try. He's going to try to knock me out, but I think he's only getting knocked out.
I honestly think that I'm a better complete MMA fighter, and this is an opportunity for me to prove that against the best fighter in the history of the UFC.
I'm going to knock him out. No doubt about that.
Welcome inside the sold-out Honda Center in beautiful Anaheim, California. Welcome to UFC 76 Knockout. It's great to be back here in Orange County as tonight, the longtime light heavyweight champion, the former light heavyweight champion, Chuck Liddell, returns to the octagon. Hi again, everybody. I'm Mike Goldberg. Welcome once again to the Ultimate Fighting Championship. No fighter in the history of the UFC has enjoyed more success than the Iceman, Chuck Liddell. He holds the all-time record for wins inside the octagon with 15. But for the first time in 4 years, Chuck Liddell enters the UFC coming off a loss. Tonight, he hopes to start his journey back to the top. And with the win this evening, he will finally set up the long-awaited match that we've been waiting a long time for. He will fight Wanderlei Silva in December. But that is with the win tonight. My partner is always Joe Rogan.
First things first, though, for the Iceman, and there is some pressure on him tonight, coming off that loss to Quentin Rampage Jackson.
There's a tremendous amount of pressure on him, but if you look at Chuck's history, every time he's had a loss before, what he's done is he's refocused in the gym, he's come back more dangerous than ever, and I expect that's what we're going to see tonight. We saw a Chuck that made a mistake with Quentin Rampage Jackson. He threw a body punch from the outside, he got caught with a right hook, he got stopped. That can happen in any fight. He was embarrassed, he's angry, he's went back to the gym almost immediately after that fight, and the word is that he's been training like he's never trained before. Keith Jardine is a very tough opponent. If you stand in front of him like Forrest Griffin did, Keith Jardine will put you away. He's a slugger, he's got heavy leg kicks, as he showed there against Kerry Shaw, but he was exposed by Houston Alexander. He made the same mistake with Houston Alexander that Forrest Griffin made with him. Stood right in front of him. If Chuck stands right in front of Keith Jardine, he could be in for a long night. But if Chuck fights his fight, Keith Jardine is a tailor-made opponent for him.
How about this opportunity for Keith Jardine? Coming off a loss, now he's in the main event. He wants to spoil that potential matchup between Liddell and Wanderlei Silva. We'll welcome Wanderlei Silva back to the Octagon in a couple of months. Tonight, we welcome for the first time Mauricio Shogun Hua.
This is a huge event. Shogun, in many people's eyes, is top two or three in the 205-pound division in the world. Forrest Griffin, though, wanted this fight, asked for this fight, and believes he has the style to beat him. Forrest Griffin is a huge light heavyweight. He walks around well over 220 pounds. He's going to come into this fight with a significant size advantage. But Shogun is a killer. He is the cream of the crop from Shootbox in Brazil. He's a vicious striker with sick Muay Thai. He's got great kicks, elbows, punches, and he's a ruthless, aggressive competitor. And this should make for one air-raising fight.
We have some spectacular matchups on the card tonight. Here, UFC 76 Knockout, led off, of course, by Chuck Liddell. And we showcase 205 pounds because we talked a moment ago about Mauricio Shogun Hua. Also some pretty good light heavyweights in Lyoto Machida. He takes on Nakamura.
Lyoto Machida is one of the most underrated light heavyweights in the world. He's a very elusive fighter with a very unusual style. He has a karate style. He moves in and out, laterally and side to side, but better than almost anybody in the sport. He holds a knockout victory over former UFC middleweight champion Rich Ace Franklin, and he's fighting Nakamura, who's a very experienced fighter at Pride. There you see him fighting Cyborg. He's fought Wanderlei Silva. He's fought some very tough guys.
And oh, by the way, Diego Sanchez back in the Octagon tonight.
This is candidate for fight of the night. Diego Nightmare Sanchez, coming off of that loss to Josh Koscheck, is now fighting Josh Koscheck's stablemate, John Fitch, a man who many people, including our own matchmaker Joe Silva, believe is the best fighter at 170 pounds in the world.
Our Rules of the Octagon, brought to you by the UFC's newest hit show, UFC Wired, hosted by none other than Joe Rogan. It premieres October 6th. Three judges score the bout. All the bouts tonight will be 3 5-minute rounds. As always, a 10-point must scoring system is in effect, with the round winner gaining 10 points, his opponent 9 or less, based on effective striking, grappling, aggression, and Octagon control. Sold out here inside the Honda Center tonight. Anaheim, California. UFC 76 available in high definition. We will begin the night at 155 pounds. They have a combined record of 25-1. Tiago Tavares and Tyson Griffin are two of the elite lightweights in the world today. But tonight, only one man will advance on their UFC journey.
Two of the lightweight division's brightest young stars, Tiago Tavares and Tyson Griffin, may give a glimpse into the future of the 155-pound weight class when they square off tonight in what could be the fight of the year.
When I get into the octagon, I feel like I am the king. Stand up or on the ground, wherever this fight goes, I will win the fight.
Beautiful triangle victory. A former law student, unbeaten Tiago Tavares, showed flashes of brilliance in his UFC debut in April against Naoyuki Kitani. But even after his comfortable three-round decision win, he admitted to having some first-time octagon jitters. That was certainly not the case in June when Tavares dominated respected veteran Jason Black.
I think Thiago's going to have a false sense of confidence if he stays on his feet with me. He's going to realize that he's going to get outclassed on his feet and outstrike him, that's for sure.
Tyson Griffin followed up his Octagon debut victory over David Lee in 2006 with two Fight of the Year-worthy wars with Frankie Edgar and Clay Guida. in both fights, the California native showed that he not only belonged on the big stage, but that he can excel in the octagon and do so in an exciting fashion.
This could be fight of the night, but I want it to be knockout of the night.
This is a fight where I'm going to show the U.S. fans and the world who is Thiago Tavares.
That is Thiago Tavares. 16-0 in his mixed martial arts career, known for his Muay Thai skills, has prepared for the last couple of fights with Brazilian top team and Marilla Bustamante, former champion, trains with Nogueira, trains with some of the best in the business today. And at the tender age of 22 years old, he and Tyson Griffin, as I mentioned before, two of the rising stars inside the UFC.
Yeah, this easily, Mike, could be fight of the night, along with Diego Sanchez, Josh Fitch. This is a phenomenal matchup. The thing about Thiago Tavares is the first fight we saw him, he looked very good. He looked very impressive. We were looking forward to seeing him again. But in the second fight, man, it was like leaps and bounds better. And what he said was just the first fight was there was a lot of pressure on him, and he couldn't perform up to his potential, but boy, did he shine against Jason Black, who is a respected competitor. Jason Black is a great wrestler. He comes from the Miletic camp. He had a great record going to that fight, and he was absolutely dominated by Thiago Tavares, including a beautiful triangle that he set up on Jason Black from double butterfly guard, which is, very hard to do. The way he did it was so slick and so quick. I was just blown away by him. He just dominated that fight with Jason Black, and he looked confident, he looked aggressive, and I look to see the same thing tonight. And against Tyson Griffin, that combination is like two trains on the same track headed at each other going 100 miles an hour.
Well, Joe, you weren't the only one impressed that night. I think Tavares, in fact, I know, earned the respect of a lot of his peers with the way he abused, if you will, Jason Black. Really opened up a lot of eyes with that victory, which was the 16th of his mixed martial arts career.
Jason Black cut a lot of weight in that fight. It was a very bad cut, but you got to give the credit to Thiago. He dominated.
Oh, look, crazy.
Yeah, Juliet Lewis here. She's a huge Chuck Liddell fan. Old school, Eye of the Tiger, Tyson Griffin, Extreme Couture. Sacramento, California is where he was born. He is now a member of Randy's Gym in Las Vegas, Nevada. And Griffin, formerly trained by David Terrell and Caesar Gracie, then he goes to some more of the best of the best with Extreme Couture and Randy Couture and the guys leading the way right now, Mike Pyle, Jay Haran. There's so many great fighters inside Randy's camp right now. It can only help improve Tyson Griffin, including when he spars and works every day with a guy like Gray Maynard.
Absolutely, and you couldn't ask for to meet a nicer, cooler, more intelligent guy. He's a very, very nice guy, supremely conditioned. He has always been in fantastic fights. Every single fight we've had with him in the octagon, from the beginning of his career, when he submitted David Lee, from then on, it's been tough fight after tough fight. Frankie Edgar, Clay Guida, and both of those fights, the Frankie Edgar and Clay Guida were just wars. The kid is incredibly conditioned. He's got great wrestling, great striking, great submissions. Caught Frankie Edgar in a vicious knee bar at the end of the last round, and Frankie Edgar was saved by the bell. It was a phenomenal fight. Every single fight we've seen this kid in, it's been a great fight. And it's just a perfect matchup for the jiu-jitsu skills of Thiago Tavares versus the wrestling, the conditioning, and the striking of Tyson Griffin.
Tyson Griffin has enjoyed a win over Bang Ludwig, who is an excellent striker in his own right. And what he did, he took him down and he beat him up. That may very well be the game plan tonight for Tyson Griffin against Tavares.
He was also the first man to beat Uriah Faber, who the WEC 145-pound champ was another fantastic fighter.
That by TKO, Joe, back in 2005. 9-1 against 16-0. Our tale of the tape for our first fight of the night, brought to you by Knox CG3, the ultimate workout formula powered by science. 23-year-old against 22-year-old, 5'6", 5'7", separated by a pound at the official weigh-ins, separated in the reach category by just an inch. What a spotlight fight to begin the night tonight. To officially get the evening started, the veteran voice of the Octagon, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live from the Honda Center in Anaheim, California for UFC 76. And now it's time to begin our first bout of the evening. Three rounds of fighting in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu and Muay Thai fighter who holds a perfect professional record of 16 wins with no losses. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 154.5 pounds. Fighting out of Florianópolis, Brazil, Thiago Tavares! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist holding a record of 9 wins with 1 loss. Standing 5'6" tall, weighing in at 155.5 pounds, fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Tyson Griffin! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Steve Mazzagatti.
Steve Mazzagatti, our referee, the beautiful Allie and Ariana here tonight. Sold out Honda Center. Great to be back in Southern California. UFC 76 knockout.
You ready? Bring it on!
Tavares, Griffin, UFC 76 is underway. Dark trunks being sported by Tyson Griffin. He will want to take this fight to the ground.
Tyson Griffin has some very good stand-up of his own. He might not want to take this fight to the ground.
Let's find out.
You can very well see him preventing the takedown and keeping this fight on the feet. And if he chooses to keep this fight on the feet, it's going to be very hard for Thiago to take him down. Tyson's a very accomplished wrestler, short, stocky, powerful build.
Would that be the approach you would suggest if you were in his corner, though?
You know what? You can never tell a guy like that what to do. He can win in any position. He can win ground and pound. He can win by submission. And Thiago can win the same way. I just think Tyson, what he can do that Thiago can't do is I think he can dictate where the fight takes place. He can decide to stand up. Thiago has some very good kicks and some Muay Thai of his own, though.
Thiago Tavares, known for his Muay Thai, but he did out-grapple the grappler Jason Black, as Joe mentioned earlier. All the fights tonight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Who will engage first? Griffin, good head movement. Good kick.
Good right hand by Tyson Griffin. He chooses to shoot for a takedown. In Thiago's guard. Thiago has a very dangerous guard, as we saw with Jason Black. He pulls off very quick submissions.
Tyson Griffin, as I mentioned, Cesar Gracie trains, a strong jiu-jitsu background as well. So many future stars from Clay Guida, Frankie Edgar, Nate Diaz, Terry Adam, all these youngsters. Roger Huerta at 155.
Look out for the leg.
Tyson spins out of it. Good knee into the midsection.
Good right hand by Tyson and a left hook.
He's coming over that looping left. Trying to come over the top. Chuck is the man who made that famous inside the octagon, but Randy Couture has used it a ton.
Scramble there. Knee to the body by Thiago and some body punches by Tyson Griffin. Tyson drops back down for the double.
Griffin up against the fence. You hear his corner call for the single.
And sweep by Thiago. Tyson stays on top. Tyson's got a guillotine on top. In Thiago's half guard, though.
Great body control. And Tavares removes the head.
You hear his corner, Tyson Griffin's corner yelling out, elbows, elbows. Don't hold the cage.
Griffin won his first 8 fights by either knockout, TKO, or submission. He's gone the distance in his last 2 battles with Frankie Edgar and Clay Guida. Griffin pushing the pace here early.
Again, he goes for the leg.
seconds remains in the round.
He's got his back. Tyson's got to get out of there. He pops out the back, and he's on top.
Mad scrambles right now, Joe. Both men.
But Tyson keeps coming out on top. Big right hand by Tyson Griffin.
Right in front of his corner is Tyson Griffin. Jay Haran, you can hear him in the background. Randy the Natural Couture in his corner tonight.
Good body punches in there by Tyson.
He's in the guard now. You hear him calling for the big elbow. Can he get the arm free and deliver it?
Tiago constantly working on the bottom, looking for things. He tries for Noma plots up, and he gets his guard passed.
And back
to his feet. Oh, and he eats a right hand. He drops for a single.
Nicely done by Griffin. Every time Tavares stands up or attempts to, Joey's punishing him, either with a knee or an uppercut, any type of strike. 15 seconds remains in the round. Good pace so far by Griffin.
Yeah, good pace, but so far Tyson Griffin is the one coming out on top in all these exchanges.
Mm-hmm.
Great job, Tim.
Time! Round one in the books.
Look how calm and relaxed Tyson Griffin is as he goes back to his corner. Barely breathing heavy. Taking some deep breaths. What a huge advantage it is to have that man in your corner. Randy the Natural Couture.
Very good round.
Perfect.
See the cast on the left arm of Randy Stills? Blocked the kick in his title defense against Gabriel Gonzaga.
You're doing a great elbow. Yes. Elbow. More elbows.
More elbows.
It's hard, but. Yeah, no, but you're clearing that. Bring that right elbow. Bounce it off his thigh. Bring it over the top.
30. You're doing great. You're in dog shape.
Jay Haron just said it best. You train with the best guys in the world.
And you could see the level of respect Tyson has for both Jay Haron and especially Randy Couture. You often see fighters listen, but you could see the respect in the eyes in the corner there. Kind of making sure with his mentor
round
that
two,
he's attacking in
ready.
A proper fashion.
That is such a massive advantage to have a coach that you truly respect that much.
And not like it's a bad corner for Tavares with Marilla Bustamante and the guys. I'm sure the respect is equal there. Pushing forward again is Tyson Griffin.
Flying knee. Tyson walked into it. He got hurt. And he's on his back now.
Big flying knee by Tiago Tavares. And that shakes up Tyson Griffin.
Fist by Tiago.
Tiago 16-0 in his mixed martial arts career.
Tyson's got 1 foot on the hip. I expect what we're going to see is him try to push Tiago off. He loses that foot on the hip. He's pressed up against the cage.
Trying to posture up.
Trying to stand up.
See if he takes him right back down. He does.
Right back down.
Tavares now has the benefit of being in front of his corner. Half guard.
Mount.
And he's got it.
Uh-oh. He bucks up, but he could be giving up his back in the process. He's got to be very careful here.
This is not good for Tyson
Griffin. Especially since he has one arm trapped. He gave up his back.
It all started with the flying knee. Got a little Frank Trish and Matt Hughes here. Carrying a man on your back, trying to choke you out.
And he's going to try to figure out a way to get rid of these hooks. The body triangle makes it very difficult, though. I mean, this is a lot of energy on Tiago's part to be hanging on like this and squeezing with his legs. I'm sure Tyson Griffin has worked extensively. Notice how Tiago tries to use that right hook to try to sweep Tyson while he's standing.
Remember, Matt Hughes choked out Frank Trigg like this.
I
I'm sure Tyson has worked extensively on this rear naked choke defense. It's much more difficult to submit a guy in MMA with a rear naked choke because of the gloves.
Great job done by Tyson Griffin.
Now he's on top.
How good was that?
He's got to be careful with the right arm. His right arm stuck in there. He's got to be very careful. He's got to stand up and yank his arm out of there as quickly as possible. That is a deep arm bar right there.
He is not out of the woods yet, Joe.
The only thing that's saving him right here is that he's pressed up against the cage, so Thiago can't roll over onto his back. His back is pressed against the cage.
He's got it free. Great job done by Tyson Griffin to avoid.
On the left-hand side.
Tavares could not finish.
Having a guy press up against the cage the way Tyson's pressed up Tavares, it eliminates so many jiu-jitsu submissions.
You can't do that.
Big punches on top by Tyson.
Tyson Griffin imposing his will now with 90 seconds remaining in the round. Gotta watch the arm again.
He tries to go for a submission himself.
Can he get it from here, Joe?
Well, he can if you can get it from half guard, but it's going to be difficult to get it on a guy like Thiago. An experienced guy, especially when he doesn't have, now, no way. Now it's out. Now Tiago's got side control, and all Tyson's doing is keeping him from passing, and maybe he can use that arm to try to regain half guard, but Tiago's got his back.
What a great chess match here.
Tyson was breathing very heavy there, too.
Now remember, he was carrying a man on his back for nearly a minute time, and now he'll do it again. My goodness.
Notice how he uses his chin to tuck down to make sure he protects his neck, and he's using his arms to try to break those legs loose.
Oh, wow. And that cut him open. That cut open Tavares. Seconds remains in the round.
Wow.
Tavares is cut.
It looks like the right eyebrow.
Griffin got Tavares up high. Tavares overcommitted, and Griffin went the other way to shake him from his back. You said this was candidate for fight of the night. What a great start. His
Big
eye
mouse.
Is swollen.
Big mouse under the left eye of Thiago Tavares.
What a great second round.
Great fight. Thiago got some good positions in that round, but he was unable to capitalize on it. Having the back in a standing position twice, having an arm bar in a very close, threatening arm bar. Let's take a look at this flying knee. This is what started off the damage. Caught Tyson Griffin coming in for a shot. Tyson was wobbly there afterwards. And here's when he had his back. That was the second time when Tyson dumped him. And Thiago immediately, immediately trying to secure one of those arms. The first armbar attempt is much closer. Great round.
Randy Couture, once again you see the cast on the left arm. Broke his arm blocking the kick in his title defense against Gonzaga. Now he hopes his young student Tyson Griffin can win. Look at the mouse under the left eye of Thiago Tavares. His undefeated record is on the line. Third and final round to open things up here tonight. Cole Miller looked great on Wednesday night at 155. What a stacked division. This whole UFC is stacked.
Thiago stands up, knee to the body.
He's been able to take his back twice. Thiago has a Tyson Griffin. Tyson with a knee. 23 years old. Griffin trying to remain patient.
What Thiago wants to do is he wants to get to the side and secure his arm around Tyson Griffin's waist. still has that that position, that Omapata shoulder lock position.
Oh, spinning out of Tyson Griffin. Beautiful scramble again.
Beautiful. And don't tell me people don't understand grappling. You hear the crowd cheer when that was happening? That's a sign of educated fans, of people that are learning and understanding all the various aspects of mixed martial arts, not just the striking, but the grappling as well. Immediately, people recognize that position.
The fastest growing sport in the world.
Knee to the leg by Tyson Griffin.
Griffin wrestled all 4 years in high school. Lots of jiu-jitsu, like I said before. Three minutes remains.
Thiago's constantly trying something. He's trying to figure out a way to get to a better position to somehow submit Tyson Griffin.
Thiago might be running out of time here. 16-0, never been beaten. Florianopolis, Brazil. Started training in judo when he was just 5 years old, jiu-jitsu at 9 years old, Tavares, and he's 22. Remains. Griffin trying to extend that jab. Hand stayed up nicely.
Thiago with the shot.
And he's
and
got
he gets
the takedown.
Down. Very nice. This is Thiago's last hurrah here. He's got him down. This is where he wanted him. He's got to do something from this position.
How many points or how much credit do you give Tavares for the attempted submissions taking Griffin's back?
That's a very interesting question, and that's one of the things that we have to figure out with mixed martial arts scoring. Because right now, the 10-point must system just isn't cutting it. We have to quantify what is more important. Near submissions, takedowns, punches, kicks. Right now, we're using a system that's designed just for striking.
And do you credit more for the taking of the back, the submission attempt, or if you're Tyson Griffin, being able to get himself out of that dangerous position?
You gotta credit the guy who put the guy in the dangerous position more than the guy who gets out of
it.
But once Tyson got out of it, he landed a bunch of hammer fists, he bruised up Thiago's face, so then it gets crazy. Like, in all honesty, even though he had his back, Tyson was never in some significant danger. He was never choking. He was never close to tapping out. It wasn't a near submission. It was a dominant position. But then you got to take into account the fact that Tyson was standing up, so it wasn't as dominant as having his back with him flattened out on his stomach.
But was it on
the control? Right here, Thiago's got his back again.
For a third time.
And he's going for an arm. He can change it to an arm if he can secure it. No, Tyson slips out of it.
So 20 seconds now left in the fight. 20 seconds.
And
what a great start to our night.
And Tyson Griffin is very close to his corner. You hear Jay Haran screaming at him.
10 seconds remains. Big hammer fist.
Thiago's got a leg. Tyson
Five
Griffin's
seconds
be
remains.
Here.
We're going to go to the judges' scorecard here.
Thiago's on top. Wow.
What a battle. They go the distance. Is Tavares now 17-0? Or has Griffin beaten Thiago Tavares here tonight in Anaheim?
Here's some scrambling here. Thiago Tavares gets the mount, and then he switches to an omoplata. Watch this. The arm gets caught in there. He locks the shoulder lock. What he doesn't do is reach over and grab a hold of the waist of Tyson Griffin, securing him in place. But he holds on to this. Now look at this spin out. Beautiful positioning by Tyson Griffin, completely spins all the way around like a clock to try to get Thiago Tavares' back. Very entertaining fight.
Hands up right now. Let's go. Hands up, team. Get him up.
Hands up. has Griffin won a decision here tonight? Or has Tavares won for the third time here in the UFC? Tyson's first loss was the decision loss at UFC 67 in Vegas to Frankie Edgar. He won a tough split decision over Clay Guida in Belfast, Northern Ireland. Big mouth under the left eye of Tavares. There he is, UFC heavyweight champion, UFC Hall of Famer. Randy the Natural Couture. The posture of Randy shows how much he respects his young studs. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. The judge score it 29-28, 30-27, 29-28, declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Tyson Griffin!
Griffin earns the decision. Tavares defeated for the very first time. And a great show of class and respect between these two rising stars. Murillo Bustamante. Here's Joe.
All right, I'm here with the winner, Tyson Griffin. Never a dull fight, man. This is like the third fight you've had that's candidate for fight of the night.
Yeah, man, I guess I keep living up to the hype. I keep trying to turn everybody down and tell everybody they're going to be wrong. I'm going to finish these guys quick, but, man, I'm in the UFC now, and all these guys are tough. That's probably the toughest kid I've had so far, man.
At any point in that fight were you hurt? It looked like when he caught you with that flying knee, how badly were you hurt?
I honestly don't remember being hurt. He did catch me in the flying knee, and I even asked my corner what put me down between rounds. I have no idea what it was, but I didn't feel too dazed at any time.
Well, take a look at the Mickey's replay and talk us through some of the action here. Some great positioning, man.
Yeah, you know, I'm very comfortable with people on my back, swing them around, get on top. It's actually the same move I hit Guida with. I think it's the same way I lumped his eye up. Kind of ironic. Just simple wrestling limp arm out of a omoplata. Just trying to transition to his back. Went for a big knee here. Hit him in the solar plexus, I think. Missed his head.
Well, congratulations on another victory in the UFC. Another exciting fight. We look forward to seeing you again. Tyson Griffin, ladies and gentlemen.
Tyson Griffin. A victor here to open things up in Anaheim. There he is, the axe murderer, Vanderlei Silva. He returns to the octagon in December, and he will face Chuck Liddell if Liddell wins here tonight in our main event against the Dean of Mean, Keith Jardine.
UFC 76 Knockout is being brought to you by Synergy, the great-tasting ultra-premium energy drink. By Mickey's Fine Malt Liquor. Mickey's, the official beer of the UFC. Mickey's, get stung. And by Toyo Tires. Toyo Tires, driven to perform. Toyo Tires, the official tire of the UFC. Later tonight, it is our main event of the evening as Chuck, the Iceman Liddell, returns to the octagon to battle the Dean of Mean, Keith Jardine. Liddell wants to start with a victory tonight on his way back to the light heavyweight championship. And he will have his hands full with that man, the Dean of Mean, Keith Jardine. Jardine coming in tremendous shape. He is very focused, and he believes tonight is the night that he will upset the former light heavyweight champion, Chuck Liddell. That fight later tonight here in Orange County. Next month, we move to the Queen City.
Former UFC middleweight champion Rich Ace Franklin wants his title back.
Relentless is Franklin.
But he'll have to get through the fearsome offense of the man who dethroned him, Anderson Spider Silva.
Oh, with a big shot. It is all over.
The rematch with Anderson Silva is a chance for redemption. It's going to be a war.
Silva ventures to Franklin's backyard to defend his title in hostile territory. Also, fast-rising heavyweight contender Brandon the Truth Vera.
Time to put up or shut up. Let's find out what the truth's made of. Don't believe the hype, just believe what you see.
Vera faces his toughest challenge yet in former UFC heavyweight champion Tim the Maniac Sylvia.
Big right hand.
Big right hand.
That's a stop.
It is over.
The Ultimate Fighting Championship presents UFC 77, Hostile Territory. Live Saturday, October 20th from U.S. Bank Arena in Cincinnati, Ohio. Only on pay-per-view.
UFC 77, tickets available, UFC.com, Ticketmaster.com, U.S. Bank Arena box office. Don't forget, log on to 77.UFC.com. David Spade here tonight, becoming a huge fan of the UFC. Great to see David Spade back inside a UFC venue tonight. 10-0 in his mixed martial arts career, 2-0 in the UFC. Brazilian Lyoto Machida welcomes former Pride fighter and ultra-talented judo practitioner Kazuhiro Nakamura to the UFC.
Two of the most respected international names in mixed martial arts today, Japan's Kazuhiro Nakamura and Brazil's Lyoto Machida, finally clash tonight in a light heavyweight battle with serious implications in the 205-pound weight class.
I am here to show that not only I can fight, but I have character as well.
A much more complete fighter than he is. I'm better than him standing up. I feel that I'm better than him on the ground. There's not a place where he's better than me.
Kazuhiro Nakamura makes his UFC debut tonight after fighting his entire career for the Pride organization. Owner of wins over Marilla Bustamante and Kevin Randleman, this light heavyweight judo standout has also locked horns with Vanderlei Silva and Mauricio Shogun Hua, making him one of the most battle-tested veterans in the mixed martial arts world today.
All of my fight in Pride have given me the confidence that I have today.
My objective in this fight is to knock him out quick in the first round.
Unbeaten Brazilian Lyoto Machida made a name for himself with wins over Rich Franklin and BJ Penn. Since then, he has continued to impress in the world-famous octagon, winning both of his fights in the UFC over Sam Holger and David Heath. Tonight, his perfect 10-0 record will be challenged like never before when he faces Japanese veteran Kazuhiro Nakamura.
Not too many people have paid attention to me in the light heavyweight division. I'm undefeated, and I plan on staying that way. And after tonight, you'll see that I have the power to knock anybody out in this division.
I'll tell you one thing. This is a funny dude. We got to watch some of the outtakes of some of his posing shots, Joe, and he did the samurai yesterday at the weigh-ins when you were there. This guy can entertain, and by the way, he can fight.
And he showed up at the weigh-ins with a face mask on. You know, one of those little masks they use to when you're cleaning out addicts. He's quite a character. He's got great judo. He's got great strikes. He's doing very well in his fight with Vanderlei Silva until he decided to take his gi top off. And in the process, Vanderlei bombed on him and wound up stopping him. But before that, he was hanging in there very well. He's his background was in judo. He trained extensively in striking as well. He's got a lot of international experience, like you said, having fought Shogun, having fought Kevin Randleman, having fought Vanderlei Silva. And he is quite a character.
Judo, as you mentioned, is his background. He was on the national team in Japan. He trained many years with Japanese gold medalist Hidehiko Yoshida, but he's really gotten into boxing now. Nakamura trains at one of Japan's top boxing gyms and actually says his hero is Muhammad Ali.
I don't know what the umbrella's all about.
I have no idea. He brought it with him on the plane.
Japanese are very strange, man. And what their idea of what is entertaining and what is interesting. I mean, he said right before the fight that he wants to show that he has character. I guess that's the umbrella.
I guess it is. Nakamura set to fight Machida. He wants to let everyone know that judo is still number one through his mixed martial arts fights. Let's see how he performs against the unbeaten fighter here tonight. Very relaxed, very experienced, and very excited to make his way into the octagon for the very first time. touching the fence for the very first time.
You running out of stuff to say?
Pretty much. You? Thank you. Thank you for your help. You can chime in a little bit. Doesn't happen to me very often, you know.
It's a weird job.
It is, but it's the best job in the world, bro.
It is the best job in the world.
And there's one of the best in the world, Lyoto Machida. 10-0 in his mixed martial arts career.
This man has a very interesting and sort of a controversial style. A lot of people don't like the style because he's very, very much a counter-striker, but I think he's got a very intelligent style. He's incredibly elusive in his fights, he takes very little damage, and he has an unusual striking style because he's karate-based. Instead of the traditional Muay Thai stance that he has, he takes on a much different stance, and he throws a different variety of kicks, very difficult to plan for. Unusual fighter to prepare for. He has a very good ground game as well. And he trains at Black House with some of the best fighters in the world, including the great Anderson Silva.
You talk about the fact that he has been criticized a bit for not being aggressive. His father, who is his karate master, and young Lyoto started training karate at the tender age of 3, even said coming into this fight, he wants to see his son be more aggressive.
Well, I think he realizes that he's got to be more exciting in order to make real money and to get a real name in the UFC. He's been successful, though, thus far. He's won, but he hasn't really lit anything on fire. A person who appreciates the real skill of mixed martial arts appreciates what he's been capable of doing. I mean, he looked fantastic against Sam Hoger. He looked great against David Heath. He stopped Rich Franklin. That was the first time Rich Franklin had ever been beat. Lyoto Machida knocked him out in Japan. He's a very talented fighter. He just hasn't been putting on those real devastating victories. He hasn't put together one of those that really lets everybody get excited about seeing the next Machida fight.
Well, let's see if tonight is that night for Brazilian Lyoto Machida. Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight matchup brought to you by Nox CG3, the ultimate workout formula powered by science. 29-year-old Brazilian against 28-year-old Japanese fighter Kazuhiro Nakamura. Machida is taller. Machida will enjoy a 3-inch reach advantage. Once again with the official introductions, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a judo fighter who holds a professional record of 11 wins with 6 losses. Standing 5'11" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds, fighting out of Tokyo, Japan, Kazuhiro Nakamura! Now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a karate fighter who holds a perfect professional record of 10 wins with no losses. Standing 6'1" tall, weighing in at 205 and one half pounds, fighting out of Belém, Brazil, Lyoto Machida! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of this contest is Big John McCarthy.
Now there's the best of the best, Big John McCarthy, our referee tonight. Ariani, Ali, our entire UFC crew, glad to be here in the sold-out Honda Center in Anaheim, California. Big John will get this one started.
All right, here we go. You ready?
Nakamura.
You ready? Let's get it on.
Against Machida. One unbeaten fighter has already lost, and here we go. They touch.
Body kick.
That had a little snap to it, Joe.
Notice how elusive Machida is. That is one of his trademarks. One of the more interesting things about his style is how little damage this guy takes on.
Nakamura trying to hunt him down.
Let go of the trunks. Let go.
Gotta let go of the trunks, John says. And he does. Nakamura has 11 wins in his mixed martial arts career.
Nakamura trains with the great Yoshida, Olympic gold medalist in judo. He's trained extensively with him. look for him to utilize that judo in the tie-ups.
Former Pride fighter, as you mentioned, Nakamura, coming over to fight in the U.S. here tonight in Anaheim.
And, you know, having been in there with Kevin Randleman, Shogun, yep, and Vanderlei Silva, I mean, he's just got so much experience. He's so relaxed and calm in there because of that.
Machida is the one with a perfect record, but you talk about, you know, who has fought more of a who's who in mixed martial arts. It's definitively Nakamura. UFC 77, Anderson Silva, Tim Silvio.
Good body kick by Machida.
Tickets still available. Log on to 77.ufc.com.
There's that judo, but it didn't work. He slipped. He's on his back. Machida countered it. Now Machida's in half guard.
Good shot. Tickets are still available in Cincinnati, Ohio. About a month from now.
Machida turning towards a Kimura.
Reaching about the midway point of round number one.
Nakamura back to his feet. Knee to the groin.
Oh, good elbow inside. Body shot. Southpaw, Lyoto Machida. A good snap on those kicks, Joe. Really spins the hips. High kick, flies.
He's got some great kicks.
Nakamura not afraid to push forward, though. In fact, he likes this fight more in close range. Try to control, utilize those judo skills.
Well, definitely Machida is the faster, more elusive fighter. This would definitely benefit Nakamura if Machida had stayed in close with him like this. But so far, he's been able to do nothing with it.
See if he gets some leverage and takes this one down to the ground. They separate.
Machida separates.
Is the kick coming again?
I'd bet on it.
Oh, down. Actually goes Nakamura on the slip. Half guard. Machida 10-0.
Machida attempts to pass and still gets stuck in between the legs of Nakamura. He's going to use his left instep to press down while he tries to sneak his right leg out. Nakamura doing a good job of keeping him in that spot.
Quentin Rampage Jackson, the light heavyweight champion. Some good light heavyweight matchups here tonight.
Elbows from Machida. And this is a new thing for Nakamura in a fight. In Pride, they're not allowed to elbow on the ground.
Machida still in half guard.
Nakamura not trying to do anything from this half guard, though.
Final 10 seconds of round number one.
Watch your head.
Machida punches and tries to pass at the same time, winds up in half guard again.
Machida definitely trying to push the pace here.
Nakamura scrambles.
And a good first round. Overwhelmed was Nakamura at the end of the round. Still to come, later tonight, Forrest Griffin, winner of the Ultimate Fighter 1, takes on Mauricio Shogun Hua. Forrest Griffin very confident. Randy the Natural Couture says, hey, Forrest Griffin is going to shock the world tonight. Forrest loves to go toe-to-toe. He is willing to exchange with this man, who we finally welcome to the UFC, Mauricio Shogun Hua. Shogun was dominant in Pride over our present UFC light heavyweight champion. He's got a ton of personality.
Is that for me?
Yeah, man. Quentin Rampage Jackson. Nakamura. We'd love to see the second round go a little bit differently.
Yeah, he's got to come up with something different here.
Ready? Ready?
So far, he's playing into Machida's strengths.
What will he look to do differently, Joe?
Well, he was unable. Oh, falls to the ground again. Machida's going crazy.
Machida trying to finish early here in the second round. That is not what he wanted to do differently.
Machida surprising him with all this aggression.
Well, we talked about it, though. Dad said, kid, you got to come and start to be a finisher. One thing to be unbeaten, it's another thing to be unbeaten and very excited.
Well, that time he passed into side control. He landed that shot, and now he's mounted.
Could this be the beginning of the end?
Nakamura is a very experienced grappler. I'm sure he's been in this position before. He rolls to his back. Not good. Machida's got to be very careful that Nakamura doesn't spin and wind up in his guard, though. And that's what he tries to do. Good job by Machida in holding on.
And he has the full mount.
Oh, big elbow from the top.
And the back again.
Excellent control by Machida. Every time Nakamura rolls, Machida's with him. He's slowly sneaking that right arm across Machida's neck.
Machida was definitely feeling the pressure to perform here today.
It's under the chin. All he has to do is get that arm free, and he got it free. That's a full rear naked choke.
Let's see if it's over soon.
As long as he keeps that arm underneath the chin.
Nope.
Oh, let it go.
Lost it. Machida trying to break down Kaz Nakamura.
Machida's legs. Machida just sits down on his neck.
You talked about the experience of Nakamura and how he remained patient a moment ago when Machida was trying to finish the fight.
Let go of the trunks.
He lost it there and winds up on the bottom. He's getting outclassed by Machida.
Yeah,
Machida mounts him again.
Good frenetic pace, and Nakamura seems like he could be running out of gas too. Now Machida's got him up against the fence.
Well, that'll be a new experience for Nakamura.
Yep. But remember, he touched the fence before when he came up. Past the midway point of the fight.
Good elbow, short elbow by Machida.
Nakamura is one tough experience, too.
Just pouring it on now. Nakamura scrambles, he gets to his feet.
Good job done by Nakamura.
He took that chance there and letting Machida almost take his back again.
Let's see if a knee goes towards the midsection, Nakamura.
So far, Nakamura really hasn't been able to mount any sort of an offense against Machida.
Work.
90 seconds remains in the second round.
One of the interesting things, Mike, about these guys that are coming over from Pride, some of them, they don't look as big as the guys that fight in the same weight class in the UFC. And maybe because the weight cutting is more sophisticated with the guys that are fighting in the UFC.
Shot. Nakamura, that's the best shot he's thrown all day.
He caught Machida throwing a leg kick. But Nakamura easily looks like he could make 185 pounds.
45 seconds left in the round. Nakamura, that's the first attack we've really seen here in the second round. First bit of offense, as you talked about, from the Japanese veteran.
Yeah, he's got to do something more than that. He's the sweep, he gets him to the ground. All right, now he's got Machida on his back.
Nakamura has survived. Now can he score? Final final 10 seconds of the round.
Nakamura throwing some elbows of his own.
Nakamura looks good here in the last 90 seconds.
Right there.
Let's take a look at some of that action here. Big right hand by Machida. Nakamura goes down. Now here's the choke. I mean, very close here. He got the arm underneath the chin, but Nakamura was able to hold on to those gloves, and those gloves make a huge difference in MMA as opposed to just straight submission grappling. You can use those gloves and hang on to them. Gives you a little handle. Now here's Machida pounding on Nakamura, pressing his head up against the cage. Nakamura really unable to sustain any real offense in that second round. Contender, former UFC welterweight champion George St. Pierre gets a huge round of applause from the fans. One of the nicest guys in the sport. And a talented fighter to boot.
Let's go, get him out. Third final round, you ready? You ready? Let's get it on, come on.
At this point, Nakamura's gotta be thinking, what do I have to do to beat this guy? He's taking some wild chances and throwing some jumping kicks at him. Oh, missed with a spinning back kick. Inside leg kick.
Let go of it.
Much more aggressive Nakamura in the third round. He's got to know at this point in time that he's way behind the judges' scorecards. He's got to do something significant.
He started to turn the tide a little bit, Joe, in the last minute and a half or so of that second round.
Yeah, and he came out throwing some wild jumping kicks in this third round. I mean, he must be hearing it from his corner. You got to do something to win this fight.
You talked about it as Machida came in. That's kind of been the knock on him, is that he hasn't been able to finish.
Nakamura attempts a sweep there. Attempts a throw, rather. It's so hard to pull that off, though, when everyone's so slippery.
That great judo background, though, that Nakamura owns.
Machida sweeps to the ground. Trips Nakamura. Nakamura, he's got him in his half guard.
Machida really had some violent ground and pound early in the second round.
And that's what enabled him to eventually take Nakamura's back.
Yep, yep. Some great fights still tonight. Liddell Jardine, our main event. Diego Sanchez, John Fitch. And of course, let us not forget the battle between Mauricio Shogun Hua and Forrest Griffin.
And for the folks at home, if you want to watch any of the unaired preliminary bouts, shortly after tonight's event, you can go to UFC.com. Machida in the mount position now. Nakamura rolls, Machida hangs on.
UFC.com, UFC On Demand, outstanding at bringing you the action. Plus the post-fight interviews. Oh, big uppercut.
You hear his screaming corner of Nakamura, realizing that he's got to make an impact in this fight.
For sure.
There's a lot of guys in the UFC at 205 pounds. They don't want anybody boring. Oh, left hand by Machida.
Machida timed that perfectly. But Nakamura almost unfazed by it. Two minutes now remains in the fight. The nose bloodied up a bit of Nakamura.
Nakamura attempts a judo throw again. Body shot by Machida, a minute 46 left. Nakamura's gotta do something drastic.
Machida with a big elbow, trying to leave no doubt in the minds of the judges if indeed this fight lasts another 80 seconds or so. Good knees by Machida. Nakamura is a tough guy to finish. Little shoulder shrug. Machida really starting to show some versatility here in the clinch. Looks up at the clock, sees that there is a minute remaining in the fight.
He took a big, deep breath there, too. I expect Machida to take a little bit of time off and then make a big surge towards the end of the round. He hears the booze.
Yeah, well, to Machida's credit, he's trying to finish it here. Trying to throw the big knee. See if he does it
again.
Another
knee.
Trying to pull down on that head. Body shot again. Machida is trying to finish.
Good body shot by Machida. They land, they're damaging, but they're not going to finish the fight. Good right hand.
20 seconds remains.
Nakamura is very good. Oh, nice elbow.
In close, Nakamura with the elbow. Too little, too late in all likelihood, though. Final 10 seconds. One last shot. We're headed to the judges' scorecards.
Nice job. Nice job. You okay?
An exhausted Nakamura is still lying on the octagon floor.
The axe murderer, Wanderlei Silva.
Huge round of applause from the fans.
Wanderlei Silva will meet Chuck Liddell in December if Chuck is able to defeat Keith Jardine here tonight.
Let's take a look at some of the action in that third and final round. Here's a Nakamura left hand. And here is an elbow by Machida.
Machida, it would appear, will remain unbeaten in his mixed martial arts career.
Hey, man, it's about that. What about that? How you doing?
Nakamura comes in, his teammate, Omagawa, fought in a preliminary fight here tonight. Showed some heart, showed the warrior spirit, but has he been beaten? Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score this contest 30-27, declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Lyoto Machida.
Unanimous decision win for the third time here in the UFC for Lyoto Machida. He beat Holger by unanimous decision, Heath by the same, and Machida beats Nakamura by unanimous decision tonight.
In here, in the Mickey's replay, you see Lyoto Machida with the mount position. He got several dominant positions on Nakamura, but was unable to finish him. But here, he landed some significant damage. Nakamura's a durable guy, though.
Coming up here tonight from the sold-out Honda Center, Anaheim, California, Forrest Griffin returns to the octagon. Remember, he fought Tito Ortiz here in Anaheim. And tonight, he's back in Orange County, coming off of an impressive performance in Belfast, Northern Ireland, taking on the ultra-dangerous 16-2 Mauricio Shogun Hua. That light heavyweight matchup, still tonight, here. Here's what's coming up inside the octagon. The Ultimate Fighter, Team Hughes versus Team Sarah, airs Wednesdays at 10 p.m. on Spike TV. Then it's the UFC's newest hit. UFC Wired with Joe Rogan premiered Saturday, October 6th. Check UFC.com for broadcast information in your area. Then on Saturday, October 20th, from US Bank Arena in Cincinnati, Ohio, it's UFC 77, Hostile Territory, as Cincinnati's own Rich Ace Franklin battles middleweight champion Anderson Silva. Also on the card that night, the return of undefeated heavyweight Brandon Vera as he takes on former heavyweight champion
Tim, the Maniac Sylvia. UFC 77, available on pay-per-view. Then on November 17th, the UFC returns to the East Coast. It's UFC 78, Validation, from the brand new Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. Tickets go on sale September 29th at UFC.com and Ticketmaster.com. Lots of great fights coming up, courtesy of the Ultimate Fighting Championship. How about the fight coming up right now? UFC 76 Knockout, Anaheim, California. The original Ultimate Fighter middleweight champion, Diego Sanchez, has always felt he was destined to be the next UFC champ. His ascension was delayed by Josh Koscheck, but tonight, Diego plans to rise again against John Fitch.
Absolutely dominating.
I think the biggest reason people haven't heard of me is just the fact that they just haven't had time to put me out there in front because of all the other great welterweights we have in the weight class right now. John Fitch. I fight like a thief. If you leave a window open, I'm going to sneak through and make you pay for it.
Looking to finish it with the choke.
Right now, I feel like I'm the best welterweight in the world. Right now, I can beat anybody at any time, and I'm just waiting for my chance to prove it.
This will soon be in its own
over. I'm going to make it a fight from the second that the bell rings.
Diego Sanchez is a monster.
I'm going to be in his face, throwing punches. And, you know, trying to take him down to the ground and beat his ass.
He's not going to let him take humanity. This might be it.
I feel like I match up very well with Diego.
Oh, big nice. Kick by Fitch.
I feel like I match up better with wrestling.
And the big high altitude takedown.
I feel like my striking's better.
Oh, he got rocked.
I'm not worried about what he brings at all. If he gives me the opportunity to take him down and ground and pound,
Diego's dropping bombs.
I'm gonna do that. You know, I'm gonna finish the fight in the first round.
Diego has been giving me some respect, but he also said he was gonna finish this fight in the first round. To me, that's not that smart and not that respectful.
I'm gonna get in his face right away off the bat. I'm gonna make this a fight.
He's gotta know that he's got a 3-round war at least coming at him.
I can impose my will and enforce my will upon him and finish him.
I feel the anticipation in the house. Perhaps the greatest fighter in mixed martial arts right now that not everybody's heard of, but they should know that John Fitch is on a 13-fight win streak, and he is 6-0 in the UFC.
He is a fantastic wrestler, former head coach of the Purdue wrestling team, captain rather, of Purdue wrestling team. He is a tall, lanky welterweight. He's got great power, and he's got a great camp out of American Kickboxing Academy. He holds some very significant wins. Brock Larson, Josh Berkman, Thiago Alves, stopped Thiago Alves, submitted Josh Berkman, beat Brock Larson by unanimous decision, submitted Juan Carnero, which is a huge feather in his cap, submitted Luigi Fiovante. He's fought some very, very tough guys. He is probably the dark horse of the welterweight division. The best fighter that most people have never heard of. And he's sat back while guys who aren't as talented as he is, have gotten much more attention. This is his time to shine, and this time is a very difficult test. Diego Sanchez is a top fight for anybody at any weight class. And at 170 pounds, especially coming off that fight with Josh Koscheck, Diego is going to be on fire tonight.
5 years in the waiting for John Fitch, who says he sacrificed so much. He moved 2,000 miles away from everyone and everything he knew, all his friends, all his family, job offers. He packed what could fit into his car and drove to California with his dog. He slept on the floor of the gym at AKA for the first month because he couldn't afford a bed. He says, I don't go out, I don't party. All I do is work and train. He ate rice and noodles, and tonight he will face his toughest opponent ever in his mixed martial arts career, but he will do so under the largest spotlight he has ever enjoyed. John Fitch, for 2 months, was Diego Sanchez,
in helping his teammate Josh Koscheck prepare for his battle against his Ultimate Fighter 1 rival. It's a big night for John Fitch here in Anaheim. In Albuquerque, New Mexico, not the guy who was defeated by Josh Koscheck at UFC 70.
Well, one of the things that a lot of people don't know about that Josh Koscheck fight is he came into that fight with a very bad staph infection. He had taken a bunch of tests, his medical tests. He was almost not cleared to fight before the fight because they thought he had something really wrong with his system. They couldn't figure out what it was. They thought maybe it was hepatitis. They didn't know what it was. And then finally realized after the fight he had a horrible staph infection. He wound up having a saucer-sized sore on his leg. Had to go through some serious antibiotics to cure it. So he fought that fight with Josh Koscheck in a significantly weakened condition. This is an interesting fight for a bunch of reasons. One, because John Fitch is arguably as good a wrestler, if not a better wrestler, than Josh Koscheck. He's taller and longer. He's a teammate of Josh Koscheck. So they got to talk about this fight. He got to help train Josh Koscheck for this fight. So he has prepared in his mind for Diego Sanchez for a long time.
Diego told me mentally, when he heard about the potential medical malfunctions, if you will, that you talked about, he said he just wasn't himself. He said it scared him a little bit. It took him off center. And Diego's such a mental kid. And that's one of his strengths. He has also left the camp where he basically grew up with Greg Jackson, still working with Rob Garcia, but now living on the West Coast in San Diego. He feels reborn, and he's ready to prove it here tonight.
Well, he's now training jiu-jitsu with the great Salo Hibero and his brother Zonde. And I think, you know, it's going to be a good change for him. It's going to be interesting to see how he comes out in this fight.
Look at him going back and forth. Little chatter before the collision.
Yeah, I want to know what Diego is yelling out to him.
Our tale of the tape for this welterweight matchup. Brought to you by Knox CG3, the ultimate workout formula powered by science. The 25-year-old winner of the Ultimate Fighter 1 against the unbeaten fighter inside the octagon, John Fitch. Sanchez has a 2-inch reach advantage. For the official introductions, once again, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, the man fighting out of the blue corner. He is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 19 wins with 2 losses and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 171 pounds. Fighting out of San Jose, California, John Fitch! And now introducing the man fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 19 wins with 1 loss. Standing 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds, fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, Diego Nightmare Sanchez! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of this contest is Herb Dean.
Gentlemen, we've gone over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions at all times. We're going to keep this fight nice and clean. Touch gloves. Come out ready to do this.
Wow. What a great stare down. It should be noted, Fitch did have to cut an extra pound. He needed a little extra time to make the required weight, which is 1 pound over. He weighed in officially at 172, cut to 171. That won't bother him as he is set to face the Tiger, who is Diego Sanchez. Welterweight shot. Look at Diego. Oh, my goodness.
Wow. Immediately goes for the takedown. Diego has an incredible belief in himself. So many fighters are beaten by their own anxiety and their lack of confidence. Diego rises far above his physical abilities just with his mind.
That's why he said it was so bothersome to him when there was all the speculation about why he was not at 100% prior to the Koscheck fight.
He is a wild man.
Sanchez has been working his hands with Rob Garcia, longtime coach Chivasca de la Hoya. He's been together with Garcia for a couple of years now.
Eats a leg kick by Fitch.
Diego is southpaw. Fitch actually even fought southpaw in helping Koscheck train for his showdown back in Houston, Texas. Diego immediately agreed to fight Sakharov. That fight didn't happen. Then BJ Penn, that fight didn't happen. Then Joe Silva said, how about John Fitch? Diego said, yeah, let's go.
Diego will turn down no one. I mean, he has an unflappable belief in himself.
He's fantastic at the scramble, and Fitch knows that. Diego told me too as well, Joe. He said, I'm going to take people down again. I don't want to knock them out. If I can, that's great. I'm going to take them down and beat them up. That's how I got to 19-0 in the first place.
Well, he's using up a lot of energy trying to take John Fitch down.
Which is not an easy task.
No, and John Fitch looks very calm, very composed.
Fitch realizes this could be the greatest moment of his mixed martial arts career. Both men actually with 19 wins. And look how more popular Sanchez is. And a lot of that is because of the Ultimate Fighter, of course. Both have 6 wins in the octagon. Fitch looks up at the clock. John Fitch, Diego Sanchez, welterweights here tonight. UFC 77, hostile territory, October 20th. U.S. Bank Arena, Cincinnati, Anderson Silva.
Fitch gets some separation. Diego got a leg.
Almost got him.
He's got him down. He's got him in a cradle.
They're up and out.
Remember how passive Diego was against Koscheck. And credit Josh Koscheck. We'll take anything away from Koscheck for the win that night.
Fitch back up to his feet. He's got Diego down.
And Fitch now takes him down. Two minutes remains in round one. Sold out here tonight. Honda Center. Tickets available in Cincinnati. Log on to UFC.com right now. And 77.UFC.com. Both men have good jiu-jitsu skills. Fitch has now earned his brown belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu from Dave Camarillo up at AKA.
Diego trying to lock on a triangle. He's cleared one arm. Tries for an arm bar. The arm is in tight.
Not a
John
time
Fitch
to try
throws
to work
some
it.
Knees to the body. But if Diego can straighten his body out and roll over, he'd let it go.
Different looking battle than it was with his teammate Josh Koscheck in Diego. This one taking place on the ground.
Well, in the fight with Josh Koscheck in the first round, with 30 seconds to go, Josh Koscheck took Diego Sanchez down. And within 5 seconds, Diego swept him and took his back.
With Fitch.
He's got to be careful here for a triangle.
Fitch's resume includes a lot of wrestling in the Midwest.
Diego keeps spinning for that armbar again.
And he's trying to overwhelm Diego Sanchez here, even though Sanchez looks for submission attempts. Good shot landed by Fitch.
Back. Diego tries to grab a hold of a leg in the process.
Fitch is the bigger fighter.
One interesting aspect of Diego's preparation for this fight is that he's been training for the first time in his career with the gi on. Salo Hibero and his camp believe that that will tighten up Diego Sanchez's jiu-jitsu.
Later tonight, It is our main event of the evening. The return of the Iceman, Chuck Liddell, as he takes on Keith Jardine, Diego Sanchez's former teammate. And there he is, the former longtime UFC light heavyweight champion. One of the world's most dangerous strikers. Jardine has very heavy hands, though. Jardine not getting a lot of love here. That's only because everybody seems to love the Iceman.
Well, if he knocks Chuck out, he'll get some love.
You got that right.
Let's go. Come on, let's make this motherfucker work. Let's get him big scrambles, baby.
Let's go, baby. Seconds out.
Set for the start of the second round. Very close first round. You talked about the jiu-jitsu training now with Rivero. Six-time world jiu-jitsu gold medalist, two-time Abu Dhabi champion. Sanchez got good jiu-jitsu with Greg Jackson and got jiu-jitsu, but wow. Fitch again. Top position, half guard. Can he pass?
Diego's going to try to sweep. He's got that butterfly on the left side. If you notice how he's using his left leg, what he's trying to do is he's trying to underhook John Fitch's leg by the foot in the ankle area, and he's going to try to pick it up and get a butterfly hook under it somehow or something to try to get a sweep. John Fitch has got an anaconda choke. Let it go.
Diego takedown.
Caught that kick. Took Fitch down.
Remembering the Ultimate Fighter, Diego loves the energy of the earth. He'd be out there in the rain, and foot is stuck in his shorts
John
right
Fitch's
now.
Yeah, foot is stuck in there.
Left foot, Joe.
He's trying to free it up in his hand. There
yeah,
he goes.
He does. Now can Diego pass?
John Fitch is going to use that underhook to try to stand up. Diego's trying to sprawl out on him and keep the weight on him, but it's going to be very tough to keep Fitch down. His left hand is caught behind Fitch's leg.
Fitch, 5 years in the waiting for this great opportunity here tonight.
Fitch is going to try to pull those legs under Diego and get him on his back. He's got him up.
And Fitch able to get a dominant position now.
Diego reaches for that switch, but he was unable to pull it off. Now Fitch is on his back. Diego trying to get hand control. Trying to keep a grip on Fitch's wrist to control his position. Meanwhile, Fitch has snuck one hook in. Now he's got Diego's back with one hook in.
What a war of attrition.
And he can finish with one hook in. He's going to have to get a good grip around Diego's neck, though. He's really trying to sneak that left hook in. Watch his left leg. If he can get his left leg in between the legs of Diego, he's got it. Nope, still doesn't have it. Watch his left leg. He's trying to get it in between the body and the leg of Diego Sanchez.
At 19-1 and his only loss by decision, Diego has never been submitted.
Keep an eye on the left leg. There it is. Now he's also pinning down Diego Sanchez's right arm if he can close that off. He's got to be careful. Diego will flip him over right up in his guard.
Diego's back up. Diego looking for some ground and pound. Trying to posture up.
And Fitch uses that to pick him up. He's got to be careful. He doesn't get caught in a triangle on the way down.
This could be interesting. Boom! What a great reaction from the crowd.
Same thing's going to happen. He's going to go up again.
Fitch looks at the clock again. 1:35 remains in the second round. Hammering into the thigh area of Diego Sanchez. Sanchez trying to answer with some shots to the back. Right towards the kidneys and the liver.
Fitch is slowly working his way around to stay on top.
Diego scrambles again.
So explosive.
That's one of the strengths of Diego Sanchez, Joe, is his ability to scramble. And Fitch talked about that coming into tonight's matchup.
Yeah, great example of that is the Diego Sanchez-Nick Diaz fight, which is just one gigantic three-round scramble.
Close guard now being utilized. Under a minute remains in the round.
Diego Sanchez trying to control the wrist and try to get a triangle.
Oh, big hammer fist. John Fitch. Fitch punishing Diego just a bit here in the round two. This is the battle we thought we would see.
Diego rolls over again to try to get an armbar.
20 seconds remains in the round.
Good job by Fitch. Again. Holding him down with the knee and landing those hammer fists.
Fitch trying to move one step closer. He's cut Diego open to a title shot at 170 pounds, where Hughes and Sarah will soon meet. Good second round for John Fitch.
Let's take a look at some more action. Now here's some of the scrambling that was going on in that round. Really dynamic scrambling in that round. Diego's on top with his legs wrapped around Fitch. Fitch stands up and drops back and dumps Diego on his back. But Diego holds on, and it made for a very awkward position. Now here, Fitch holds him down with a knee and lands some hammer fists to Diego's head. Here's some more of those hammer fists right behind the ear. And you see Diego wince.
Third and final round. It's a close fight, Joe. Sanchez with that look in his eye still. Fitch.
Ready.
Hoping tonight he will shine under this bright spotlight, and so far so good. But this fight is very close.
Well, Diego's got to know it's close, so I think he's going to really try to pour it on this round.
He came storming out at the beginning of the fight. High kick, no problem there. Diego was ready. Had his hand up. Ducking under his Fitch. Wonder if they'll go toe-to-toe for a bit.
Good right hand by Fitch. And takedown, he goes for a guillotine.
Can he finish? Diego Sanchez.
There's no arm in.
Looking to choke out John Fitch.
John Fitch just gave the thumbs up. He said he's fine.
Sanchez will try to extend the body.
And if he is fine, and if he's not in danger here, Sanchez is wasting a tremendous amount of energy trying to squeeze the neck. And when Fitch pops up, he'll be on top, and Diego will be gassed.
Fitch is out. Get a great reaction here for the sold-out Honda Center.
And Diego immediately scrambling, tries to go for a leg, immediately scrambles to butterfly guard.
The Purdue wrestling captain avoids the early submission attempt here in round three.
By John Fitch.
So again, Joe, the question, do the judges give more credit to submission attempt or submission avoidance? Very, very close fight. Under 3 minutes remains.
You gotta give more credit to the submission attempt. And again, he's going for Kimura this time, trying to pry out John Fitch's right arm. And he's doing it in full guard, which is a great place to pull it off.
Will AKA go 2-0 against Sanchez? Koscheck defeating Diego for the first time in his career.
Fitch has got his arm free. Diego pulling his leg up, trying to get an omoplata, it looks like, or perhaps a triangle if he can get that left leg free. If he can get the left leg past John Fitch's right arm.
It's work, guys, come on. It's work.
2 minutes to go, John Fitch just punching from the top.
.145 remains. All we ever heard, if you asked people to describe John Fitch with one word, it was beast. 90 seconds.
Diego again attempting to get that Kimura.
Fitch is a very strong and very big 170-pound fighter.
Fitch looked up at the clock right there. He's trying to pass. Diego scrambles.
And the conditioning of these guys, undeniably outstanding. Sanchez looks up at the clock. Sees that there's 1 minute remaining in the third and final round.
1 minute, baby!
Is John Fitch 1 minute away from the biggest win of his career?
John Fitch is able to hold Diego down. Diego, get a triangle. Diego's got a triangle. He's right in front of us. It's locked in.
Looking to finish again.
John Fitch is in deep trouble.
Diego Sanchez.
And he's on top.
Couldn't hold on.
Very nice submission defense by John Fitch.
Joe, you pointed out earlier the educated crowd that we have present day here in the UFC. They react again.
Yeah, immediately as soon as they saw it. And Diego can block it up again.
15 seconds left.
If he can grab a hold of his right foot, he can pull it down again. The leg is over the top.
10 seconds, Joe.
He's got to grab it. He's got to cinch it up with his left leg. Oh, John Fitch is out.
We are headed to the judges' scorecards. What a battle.
Great fight. What a tactical battle.
Has Fitch done it? Or did Diego score enough points with those continuous submission attempts?
Let's take a look at the replay. Here's the guillotine. Immediately, Diego locks onto that thing. In full guard, and John Fitch gives the thumbs up to the referee when he's asking him if he's okay. Now here you see Fitch pop out of it. And as soon as he pops out, immediately Diego scrambles. Tries to grab a hold of a leg. And here's the triangle, and this was very close. John Fitch was in deep trouble here. But he was able to turn and twist and torque his body and pop his head out of there. Wound up on top, stayed on top, held that position. Diego again tried the triangle after that. Great submission defense by John Fitch and, you know, some great aggressive submission attempts by Diego Sanchez.
Who will work their way to their 20th win in their mixed martial arts career? Will it be that man, Diego Nightmare Sanchez? Or will it be John Fitch? This might be the longest 2 minutes of these men's mixed martial arts career. Waiting for the judges to render the decision. The Boilermaker tattoo on the right shoulder of Fitch. Born in Fort Wayne, Indiana.
Yeah, beautiful.
Heading right to West Lafayette to wrestle collegiately in the Big Ten Conference. Bruce Buffer still gathering the scorecard from each of our three judges. Here's Bruce Buffer with the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. Cecil Peoples scores the contest 30-27, Fitch. Marcos Rosales has it, 29-28, Sanchez. And Richard Bertrand scores it, 29-28, for the winner by split decision, John Fitch!
Fitch has done it! John Fitch defeats Diego Sanchez. Here's Joe.
All right, I'm here with the winner, John Fitch. John, first of all, John, congratulations. It was a great fight. And this fight kind of highlights the scoring conundrum that we have over what is more important, positioning or submissions. Give us your thoughts on the fight.
Yeah, I mean, I felt like I dominated the entire fight. There's a couple times I got put on my back. I got put in submissions, but they weren't close to being anywhere near danger. I felt good throughout the entire fight. I thought I was going to stand most of this fight, but I felt really comfortable once I got into the clinch. I felt like he wasn't going to overpower me there. I was having an easy time defending takedowns, so I said, might as well just go ahead and grind this one out.
Now, being a teammate of Josh Koscheck and Josh having already had a fight with Diego, how much of an advantage was that going into this fight? Do you feel like you had to prepare for him twice?
No, because when I was helping Koscheck prepare, I was Diego. I switched to southpaw, I watched tapes on Diego and tried to copy his style and the things he did. So it's kind of an unfair advantage because I kind of knew what he was doing and how he was going to do it.
Take a look at the Mickey's replay and talk us through some of the action here, John.
So sitting up, coming backside. I was looking to keep my head out, come around, but he locked on, so I thought I'd just pick him up and try to drop him on his head. Not too bad. And then he had a deep guillotine, but if everybody knows that I'm pretty impossible to choke. I've been in a deep choke every single one of my fights. I come out every single time. You know, it's kind of like my trademark. My hair just, he got a real nice triangle here, and he was in a good position because I couldn't circle the way I needed to defend because the fence was there. So last ditch effort, I had to step all the way around his head to pop my head out.
Well, congratulations, John. It's a big victory for you. We look forward to seeing you again. And now the world knows who John Fitch is. John Fitch, ladies and gentlemen.
14 straight wins for John Fitch. Diego Sanchez, nice enough to talk to Joe in defeat.
All right, I'm here with Diego. First of all, Diego, you must be disappointed.
You know what? Let me say something. You don't need a boo. You don't need a boo.
Well, you gave a great effort. It was a great fight. Give us your thoughts on the idea of scoring. What is more important in your opinion? Is it submissions or near submissions, or is it position?
Well, you know what? I went for the submissions. He got out. He controlled the position. I give him the win. I got to get back to work harder. Work on what I do, get back in here, get back on the W side, you know. He beat me fair and square. I'm going to take it like a man and get to work, you know what I mean?
Well, congratulations on an entertaining fight. I'm sorry you didn't come out with the win, but I know we'll be back. We'll see you again. Diego Sanchez, ladies and gentlemen.
Nicely done and a great show of class and respect by young Diego Sanchez, defeated tonight. Take a final look backstage at Mauricio Shogun Hua. One of the most dangerous 205-pound fighters in the world today is set to finally make his long-awaited UFC debut. And he will have his hands full against the ultra-popular Forrest Griffin, one of the most recognized fighters in the game today. Forrest Griffin is set to return to the octagon here tonight. Tonight, it's Anaheim. Next month, we move to Cincinnati, Ohio.
Former UFC middleweight champion Rich Ace Franklin wants his title back.
Relentless is Franklin.
But he'll have to get through the fearsome offense of the man who dethroned him, Anderson Spider Silva.
Oh, caught with a big shot. It is all over.
The rematch with Anderson Silva is a chance for redemption. It's going to be a war.
Silva ventures to Franklin's backyard to defend his title in hostile territory. Also, fast-rising heavyweight contender Brandon the Truth Vera.
Time to put up or shut up. Let's find out what the truth's made of. Don't believe the hype, just believe what you see.
Vera faces his toughest challenge yet in former UFC heavyweight champion Tim the Maniac Sylvia.
Big right hand, big right hand! That's enough stop! Oh, it is over!
The Ultimate Fighting Championship presents UFC 77, Hostile Territory, live Saturday, October 20th from US Bank Arena in Cincinnati, Ohio, only on pay-per-view.
The
UFC recently partnered with Maxim Magazine to give away a VIP trip for four to an upcoming UFC event. And now this month, check out Maxim for a great article featuring top UFC fighters showing you some of the secrets of mixed martial arts. Maxim Magazine on newsstands now.
Now, everybody has given their Maxim tonight and their maximum effort. Diego Sanchez, a great show of respect and class. John Fitch, a victor in his brightest moment. Coming up, light heavyweight matchup. One of them we've been waiting for. We've been waiting for him all tonight, Joe. Forrest Griffin welcomes Shogun to the UFC. There are times I've been with you for a long time here. Announcing the Ultimate Fighting Championship, you get pretty fired up about certain rivals. You're pretty fired up about Shogun coming into the cage tonight.
Look, this is one of the best things about the acquisition of Prize, that we get to see all these top fighters that I've watched on pay-per-view over and over again. We get to see them live in the octagon. And I think this is a phenomenal matchup. The matchup of Forrest Griffin versus Shogun is perfect. We're going to get to see Forrest step up and fight a top contender of the world, and we're going to get to see how Shogun deals with a bigger, stronger guy who's got all this octagon experience.
All the octagon experience is owned by Forrest Griffin, but what is it that impresses you most about Shogun Hua?
Well, Shogun is the cream of the crop of Shootbox. And Shootbox, if you've watched any of the Pride fights, yeah, see these guys fight, they're known for just insane, wild, reckless, abandoned, aggressive style. And Shogun is the wildest of the group. He's got crazy 360 roundhouse kicks that he throws, like capoeira style. He's got great leg kicks, great punches. He can submit guys. He submitted Kevin Randleman with one of the nastiest leg locks I've ever seen in mixed martial arts. He's just a bad dude. Everyone's afraid of Shogun at 205. And having that guy in the UFC, and the craziest thing about this fight is this is a fight Forrest Griffin asked for, which tells you a lot about the heart of Forrest Griffin.
We already knew Forrest Griffin was a warrior tonight. He will look for what could be the biggest upset of his career. Or will tonight be the night that Shogun Hua arrives and wins here in the UFC?
I said, man, I want to fight that Shogun guy. I want to fight Shogun forever, man. I know he's the kind of guy that's going to come out and get right in your teeth, and it's going to be a fight.
They remain in the stand-up box, and then Shogun now, that's Rock Nogueira.
Yep.
I clench of the patented knees from the Shootbox veteran.
Whoa, I never saw that coming.
Oh, nice real takedown.
Another big punch.
I've always wanted to fight in the UFC, and fighters are coming to the United States, which right now is the center stage for the sport. And I see it as a natural evolution of the sport, and I'm very happy to be here.
I like the way he fights, but I think I can beat him.
And pushes forward with a great combination.
Oh, nice right hand by Forrest. Good knees to the body by Forrest. Good uppercut. That's it.
I don't think there's anybody that I can't go out there and make a good fight with.
It's important to me not only to win, but to win convincingly. I want to show how good I am, and I want to show the American public that I'm here to stay.
I think I'm a little quicker than him, you know? I think I can move, I can press the action, I think I'm stronger than him in the clinch.
I respect Forrest Griffin. I think he's a good fighter, he's a skilled fighter, but I make no mistake about it, I'm going to go for the knockout.
Of course he's going to bring the best out of me, you know? I'm excited about it right now. I'm excited about training for this fight. I'm excited about fighting one of the best guys in the world, you know? And I like my chance.
Martial arts in America, that even though this young man hasn't fought UFC before, even though this is his first fight. When we were at the weigh-ins yesterday, they were chanting out, the crowd was chanting out, Shogun, Shogun. We're talking about thousands of people, hardcore fans, very excited to see this young man. The Shoebox Camp is famous for their wild fighters, wild, aggressive fighters, and he is thought to be the best of that group. Even thought so by Wanderlei Silva. He won the middleweight Grand Prix in Pride. He's knocked out such great fighters as Alistair Overeem, Ricardo Arona, submitted Kevin Randleman, stopped Quentin Rampage Jackson, our UFC light heavyweight champion, in the very first round with a ruthless attack of body shots, knees, and kicks. He's just a bad dude.
He is ranked by many publications around the world as the top 205-pound fighter in the game today. That's ahead of Rampage, as you talked about, ahead of Wanderlei, ahead of Chuck, ahead of Dan Henderson, and he's been right there for quite some time.
And he's only 25 years old.
From Curitiba, Brazil, it's a who's who list of victors in which he has defeated. And the amazing thing about Shogun is that he brings it and continues to bring it in a style that everybody loves to watch.
Yeah, I mean, that is just a crazy camp, that Shoebox Camp. They're just a bunch of wild animals down there. And this kid has, the future is, I mean, sky high for this guy. He's only, like I said, he's only 25 years old. This is his octagon debut. No matter what happens tonight, he's only going to get better. And in many ways, he is the most exciting acquisition of Pride because, unlike Wanderlei Silva, this young man hasn't been stopped significantly before. And he holds a brutal, vicious first-round knockout win over our current UFC light heavyweight champion, Quentin Rampage Jackson.
Shogun has won 12 of his last 13 fights, 9 of those by knockout or TKO. He'll throw flying knees. He'll throw crazy Taekwondo kicks. He says tonight he will win the crowd over with his style. This crowd already knows who Hua is, and they love him. Vegas, training in Extreme Couture. Griffin also still working at the Giants Training Center. And Forrest Griffin says he will make Shogun pay when Shogun rushes him here tonight.
Man, I can't wait for this fight.
Forrest Griffin, really, you know what? He was defined by the Bonner fight and redefined even in a loss to Tito Ortiz here at UFC 59. He hopes tonight here at the Honda Center will be the greatest moment of his mixed martial arts career. Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight matchup, brought to you by Knox CG3, the ultimate workout formula, powered by Zions. Griffin is 3 years older than Shogun, 2 inches taller, and has a 3-inch reach advantage. Hua is finally here, but Griffin stands in his way. For the official introductions, once again, the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is sponsored by Mickey's Fine Malt Liquor, the official beer of the UFC. Mickey's, get stung. And now, 3 rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a Muay Thai kickboxer who holds a professional record of 16 wins with 2 losses. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Curitiba, Brazil. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight he is making his Octagon debut, Mauricio Shogun Hua! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a freestyle fighter who holds a professional record of 14 wins with 4 losses. He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, ladies and gentlemen, Forrest Griffin! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of this contest is Steve Mazzagatti.
All right, gentlemen, you know the rules. We all expect a good, clean, fair fight. You need to obey my commands. Protect yourself at all times. Hook them up. Good luck.
Griffin wanted this fight. Now he's got it. Randy the Natural Couture predicts Forrest Griffin will upset Shogun here tonight. Honda Center is sold out. Steve Mazzagatti gets us started. We are underway. Shogun comes out quickly. Remember how selective Forrest was with his striking in his last
right leg kick. Very good right leg kick by Forrest. Good takedown defense. Ninja tries to take him down. Gives up his back. He rolls. Forrest on top.
Forrest got to watch the up kick. And his
Forrest
arm in
there. Passes. Forrest gets his back.
Griffin
Ninja
with
rolls.
A great pace early.
Excuse me, Shogun. I keep calling him his brother's name.
Forrest stepped away a lot against Hector Ramirez as well. That little stutter step.
Inside
get that
mental
break. Good leg kick by Hua.
And good leg kick counter by Forrest. Good right hand.
Forrest wants to keep this fight selective, if you will, Joe. Step in and out. Not let Shogun put the pace.
Shogun with the takedown. He's past the half guard.
Put the pace at his speed.
Forrest brings it back to full guard.
They love Forrest Griffin here. I guess all that's Forrest or Shogun.
Forrest controlling Shogun's wrist on the left side.
Shogun can't pass. Forrest's work ethic is one of the best in the business. Randy Couture says he literally has to kick him out of the gym. Shogun trying to posture up. Oh, good wrist control by Forrest Griffin.
Great control by Forrest. Great avoiding any significant damage so far.
Now he blocked the hammer fist as well, Joe.
Yeah, he's doing a great job there of doing that.
Shogun can't pass again. Close guard utilized by Forrest Griffin.
I'm impressed so far with Forrest guard. I'm impressed with his wrist control and elbow from the bottom.
Yep.
You know, a lot of what Forrest's problem was going into, like, say, the Tito Ortiz fight, was thinking that he belonged there. And I think that Tito Ortiz fight taught him a lot.
Absolutely.
I think he realized in losing a fight, by a very close decision, which a lot of people thought that he should have won.
And he's up. Uppercut.
Again, he used the underhook from half guard to get up. Inside leg kick by Forrest. Forrest, a takedown.
Gotta watch the knees with Shogun. High kick. Forrest.
Nice leg kick by Forrest.
Shogun pushing forward. Good exchange, both men. And the takedown by Griffin.
Shogun attempts a sweep, but Forrest gets his back. Shogun's gonna try to roll for a knee bar. He likes to roll into guard. Good elbow from the bottom by Shogun.
Both men striking from the bottom effectively here. Both men deliver a strike. Griffin
gonna try to grab a hold of one of those legs and sweep to the side. Let Shogun up. Interesting.
Griffin is very confident in his ever-evolving stand-up game.
What I like about what he's doing now in this stand-up, he's being very intelligent with it. He's moving around more, giving more angles. The exchange kicks.
Jab connected.
Left hook by Forrest.
There's a mouse on the forehead of Shogun.
That's a big knock.
Shogun forward with the right. All four switches directions nicely. But he ate one.
Shogun
and the takedown by Hua.
Takedown. Forrest right back up.
Looking up at the clock is Forrest Griffin. 45 seconds remains in round one.
Good takedown defense by Forrest. He's got a wizard. Shogun's got him down.
Forrest even with the open hands, trying to box the ears a little bit. Griffin training with Extreme Couture now. You got Shootbox and Extreme Couture. Could we ask for anything else?
Great defense by Forrest.
He's got his back for a moment.
He's back on top.
Final seconds of round number one. What a start. How good is that?
Let's take a look at some of the action in that first round. Here's a takedown by Forrest Griffin. Forrest with a trip. Winds up on top. And here's a left by Shogun. And a left by Forrest.
That is a knock.
And I need you to stay on top. You're doing good when you're on top. You're beating him right now. Don't
you,
settle for that.
You on the hook.
Let's go.
He cannot hold
the mic. Grab the stool.
You hear Randy Couture yelling at him. If you underhook, he cannot take you down.
Shogun's got his hands full, Joe. I don't think anybody's surprised, though. Forrest always comes to fight.
Round two, bring it on!
Round two.
I think we're seeing a Forrest that's coming into his own. And he realizes he belongs in here with the top fighters in this division.
You talked about it. It was right in this building, Tito Ortiz.
Leg kick by Shogun.
Oh, good body shot. Forrest, good head movement, tucked under. Now Forrest with a couple of jabs. That's the one thing that he wanted to do, was utilize an active jab. Keep Shogun on the outside.
Shogun drops to a single, he gets the takedown. Forrest goes for a guillotine. He doesn't have the arms clasped. Forrest is really doing an excellent job of avoiding damage in his full guard. And a lot of younger fighters can really learn from this example. He does a great job of protecting himself from hammer fists, punches, he controls the posture. See, look at that.
Utilizing close guard again.
He's doing a great job of frustrating him by really grabbing a hold of the wrist, controlling his arms.
Forrest came in super confident for this.
Oh, big right fight. Hand by Shogun.
Griffin wanted an aggressive opponent, and he got it in Shogun and bloodied up now. Forrest Griffin's right back up.
Forrest back to his feet.
But he got hammered. Got hammered by that shot a moment ago.
Forrest has a significant amount of scar tissue on his face.
And the takedown. He sweeps the leg and takes Hua down. Some of these UFC vets say, yeah, welcome to the Octagon, Fly Guys, but that doesn't mean you're going to walk right into our house and win. He's cut big time.
It's hard to see how bad that cut is. A lot of times cuts in the face tend to bleed very badly.
Just avoided the knee. It's at the bridge of the nose, it would appear, Joe.
Forrest is no stranger to being cut and hurt in a fight, though.
Kind of right in the middle of the forehead, is, if we can tell from this angle.
Stuffs the takedown, spins, takes Shogun's back. If he can pop his leg out, he's got his leg out.
Forrest right in front of his corner. Mike Pyle and Randy Couture.
Shogun takes a deep breath.
And lets the hands go down for a moment. Oh, and again.
That's not a good sign. And Forrest is going to feed off that. Forrest is going to turn the heat up. You hear his corner screaming that he's gassing. Inside leg kick by Forrest.
He is. Look at his hands, Joe. And look at the way he's breathing.
This is a serious pace these guys are setting.
Griffin, a workaholic, as we talked about. He should not gas. Should being the key.
Well, this is, this is a sprint. It's almost impossible to not get exhausted in this kind of a fight. But Shogun seems to be the more tired fighter at this point.
Griffin ducks under again. Now the blood's kind of traveling into his right eye. You saw him wince there, Joe.
With a lot of fighters, that could throw them off, but it's not going to throw off Forrest. Like I said, he's been there before, and he eats a left hook.
Body shot by Griffin. High kicks are going nowhere. Wow, Shogun looks almost exhausted here.
Forrest has really got to turn it up. He can steal this round. Really solidify it. Stuck that takedown again. He pulls out.
Wow.
And he's on top. This is all Forrest Griffin. Forrest has got his back.
Shogun slips out. Half guard.
Shogun was exhausted before this got to the ground. He's got to be really beaten down now. Forrest Griffin maintaining this position, landing some good shots.
35 seconds remains in the round.
Shogun looked up at the time. He is exhausted.
Griffin, can he finish here? Got the arm pinned. Got the arm between the legs, Joe, and he's teeing off. Mazzagatti on top of the action.
See, Mazzagatti took a good look at him there. Forrest Griffin maintaining his position. He looked up at the clock. He knows there's 10 seconds to go. He's going to try to turn it on now. His arms are so tired, though. You see how slow those punches are coming.
What a great finish to round two by the Ultimate Fighter.
What an exciting fight.
Quentin Rampage Jackson watching closely.
Very interested observer right there. Let's take a look at the elbow that cut Forrest Griffin. Here it is right here. Bang! Right on the bridge of the nose.
See his reaction, his facial expression? Like, ah, oh, man.
It's actually, oh, wow.
That's nasty. Stitch is one of the best in the world, though.
That's a brand new cut. That's not even over scar tissue.
Breathe. Couple more deep breaths for me.
Well, Forrest has never claimed to be that handsome. He said that many times.
Let's go! Check it out! Let's go, guys! Out! Out!
Out! Let's go! Let's go!
Out!
Out!
Vanderlei Silva.
Vanderlei looks very concerned.
Man, he's got to be nervous for his teammate. And Vanderlei, if Chuck
Mayhem
wins tonight.
In the background.
Yeah, if Vanderlei sees Chuck win, then Vanderlei knows he'll see Chuck inside the octagon in December.
Go for it. Put it
third
in.
And final round.
Last round, guys. Bring it on.
Forrest Griffin can pull this fight away here in this last round.
He's got to be careful, though.
Inside leg kick by Forrest.
How much cardio does Shogun have left?
He's got the takedown. Forrest grabbing a hold of the leg, looking for a triangle.
Shogun trying to spin out a guard, can't do it.
Very good guard.
I was going to say, and Griffin's ground defense probably looks as good as we've seen it, Joe.
Yeah. He obviously trains in all areas.
The ultimate fighter, one of the original winners, Forrest Griffin.
You hear Steve Mazzagatti tell him to get off the cage, but all he's trying to do is push off of it.
Forrest is saying, stand us up. He's not doing anything. Forrest threw a good elbow from bottom position earlier in this fight.
Even though he's not doing anything, he's on top. Forrest has got to be concerned with how the judges are viewing this.
Octagon control. Based on effective striking, grappling, aggression, and octagon control. Those are the rules of the octagon, brought to you tonight by UFC Wire.
Shogun going for the other, Forrest going for the other plata. He's got it.
Can he finish here, Joe?
Yes, he can. He can get the back as well.
He's got the back
the
now. Forrest reverses
there,
again.
He's got the back.
Griffin smothering Hua.
Shogun's got a hold of that leg. He's trying to take Forrest down, but he winds up on the bottom.
Forrest in half guard.
Forrest keeping that elbow on Shogun's face.
Teeing off with the left. Couture predicted rampage over Liddell. Gonzaga to defeat Croca. Rampage to beat Henderson. And he predicted his teammate Forrest Griffin would upset Shogun Hua tonight.
If Forrest can get out of this half guard and get to a more dominant position, he can land some real damage here. He's landed some good punches from this position.
I wonder if Shogun's got anything left, Joe.
Well, Forrest is making him work. He gives up his back again. And Forrest punches him in the ear a few times. Uppercuts underneath.
Griffin has established a pace that has gassed Shogun Hua.
Knees to the body by Forrest. Shogun can do nothing to turn him up. He tries to roll over into his guard. He's in half guard. And Randy Couture likes to stay in this position. He likes to do ground and pound from this position. And Forrest Griffin, being one of his disciples, I'm sure he likes this position as well. Likes to hold on to the leg. Gives him something to put his weight on and keep the guy in that position.
Final minute of the fight. The natural in the corner. Up Griffin.
Forrest is sneaking that leg out. He's going to try to mount.
Yes, posture up.
You hear Couture yelling towards Griffin to posture up. He's trying to get that right leg free and get a full mount here. But he's happy to go from half guard, as you talked about.
He's got his back.
30 seconds of the fight.
Forrest's got his back with both hooks in. He's flattening him out.
20 2 seconds remain.
This is a deep chop of Fox. Got the rear naked chop.
15 seconds. Griffin has pulled off the upset.
And Mike, this is what we were talking about all along. Forrest Griffin just needed to believe that he belongs in there with the top fighters in the world. The Tito Ortiz fight was the beginning of that. And tonight, what an upset. What a fantastic victory for Forrest Griffin.
The man who helped redefine the Ultimate Fighting Championship.
Let's take a look at it again.
Has beaten Shogun.
Not just beat him, but finished him on the ground, submitted him. He's got that rear naked choke in, and you see
Shogun tap. There's a tap on the leg. There it is. You see the right hand on the left leg of Forrest Griffin.
What a fantastic victory for Forrest Griffin.
Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Steve Mazzagatti has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes. 45 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by tap out due to a rear naked choke, Forrest Griffin!
Forrest just wants to hug anybody who's around right now. What a win! Here's Joe.
I'm here with the winner, Forrest Griffin. How happy are you, man?
Oh, my God. You know, I haven't done that many drugs, but I think this is what ecstasy feels like, baby. Hey, thank you guys so much. I want to thank Shogun. He's a bad man. I don't know why he just keeps coming forward even when he's really tired. I was really tired. I was really tired. I got to thank everybody from Randy, all the guys, everybody from Zion's, everybody from the Combat Club. You guys, I thank you so much. It takes a lot of people to get good at this fighting nonsense.
But you have gotten so good in your career. Your career has been brought up. This moment clearly defines you as one of the top 10 fighters in the 205-pound division. For a long time, you were knocking at that door, and you're in now. How does that feel?
You know, I really felt like I was there. I felt great. I had a great camp. And then Keith knocked me out. And, you know, I got depressed and sad and ate a lot of cookies. But, you know, my friends and family, they told me, Forrest, you're not good at anything else. You better get back to fighting.
Well, you're fantastic at this. Take a look at the Mickey's replay. Now, this is where he caught you early on in the fight. He hit you with an elbow. How much did this affect you?
It affected me every time I was on my back. Because you look, well, I smile right here. And I just wink at him. I said, yeah, that was nice. That was nice. I ain't hating. That was awesome.
Now, here's the end of the fight.
Oh, that's me checking the clock because I'm tired. I would say effing tired, but I promised my mom I wouldn't cuss after this one. Nothing fancy there. It's not really even a good choke, but fatigue is a son of a bitch. Oh, I guess I cussed. Oh, well.
Not only did you, I think you're the first guy to ever finish him in the octagon, or actually in a fight, in an MMA fight.
Well, you know, he had that worst freaking elbow popped out against Coleman, but, you know, I'm sure it's not the way he wanted to start his career in the UFC off, but, you know, all the love to him and his guys, even though they were mad dogging me all week, I got nothing but love for him. I'm sure he'll pick it back up. He is one of the best in the world.
Well, congratulations. Now you are one of the best in the world. Welcome to the top of the food chain, Forrest Griffin, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, thank you again. And I said it every time. I ain't that great, but I will fight anybody.
You are that great. You are that great.
Make it a fight, brother.
The original Ultimate Fighter has just won the biggest fight of his mixed martial arts career. And speaking of the Ultimate Fighter, Wednesdays 10 p.m. on Spike, the newest Ultimate Fighter, Team Hughes versus Team Sarah. Here's what's coming up this week.
This Wednesday on the next all-new Ultimate Fighter. After victory in the first fight, Team Hughes is fired up and ready to go to war.
It's that military mindset for Hughes' team. We're hungry for blood.
Leaving Matt Serra feeling the pressure.
I hate this suck. I can't wait to fight.
But with one fighter already gone, is Team Serra about to lose another?
I gotta go deal with a bitch. I'm kicking this guy to f*** off the show.
It's an all-new Ultimate Fighter. Team Hughes versus Team Serra. This Wednesday at 10 on Spike TV.
A big win for Forrest Griffin.
here tonight, and what a win indeed. Right from his corner, right to the broadcast position, UFC Hall of Famer Randy the Natural Couture will help us call our main event of the evening. The main event in the light heavyweight division tonight will feature the former longtime light heavyweight champion, Chuck the Iceman Liddell, as he is set to take on the Dean of Mean, Keith Jardine. Wow. Randy the Natural Couture is here. Joe Rogan, I got to do this. I know. We got to get to the main event, but how about your guy, Forrest Griffin, brother?
Man.
Oh, man. I predicted it. I just thought he was going to have it tonight. Every guy from Pride that steps in here, this is a whole new deal in the cage. The rules, everything from top to bottom, it's different. It takes an adjustment. Shogun did a great job. He is a tough cat. Forrest looked awesome tonight.
That's four in a row on your picks, though, man. I want to head to Vegas with you right now.
I don't know. They start calling me the Swami.
All right, you know what? This was an outstanding moment for Forrest Griffin. I mean, his ground skills have progressed so much to go along with his newfound stand-up skills.
I felt they were underestimating his ability on the ground all along. He's very, very good here. It's just not where he chooses to be. He likes to make it exciting. He likes to brawl. And that's usually what we see. Shogun forced him to work on the ground tonight.
All right, let's talk about the main event now, Randy and JoJo. Let's start with you about Chuck Liddell and perhaps where he is mentally as he comes in after being beaten for the first time in 4 years.
Well, as far as a performance is concerned, this is the best case scenario for him. He's obviously far more determined now. He's angry, he's upset and embarrassed by his loss. And coming into this fight, he's got a tailor-made opponent. Yeah. He's got a guy who doesn't ever show submission skills, doesn't ever try to take anybody down, wants to stand and bang, which is Chuck's forte. This is a perfect fight for Chuck to show his dedication, show that he has refound his focus, refound his drive, and that he has the will and the need to get back to the top of the 205-pound division.
Joe, you've talked about it. Randy, you have as well. You often find out more about a fighter when they're coming off a loss, but that's also the case for Keith Jardine, and he was beaten by Houston Alexander, and instead of maybe going to a fight in the prelims or disappearing for a little while, he gets thrown right into a main event. It's a huge opportunity.
Absolutely, and I'm sure he's scratching his head, a relatively unknown guy like Houston coming in and knocking him out the way that he did, and now he's facing a knockout artist. He's, again, got to be thinking, out, what am I doing? But I think this is a win-win for him. Even if he lost this fight, if he has a great showing, it's still Chuck Liddell. He's got great right kick. He's got a great straight right hand. Chuck is coming off of a knockout, too. The potential is there. So Jardine's got nothing to lose. He can go let it hang out in this fight.
You want to try to make it five in a row? come on.
I think it's going to be Chuck's night. Chuck's been here before. He's lost before. He's recovered. He's going to be back in championship form tonight.
All right, Joe, you want to try to make it one in a row?
No, I'll just stay with being a loser. I would think if I had a bet on it, I would surely bet on Chuck Liddell. But we've seen many times in this crazy sport, anything can happen. If Chuck makes a mistake and if Keith Jardine is prepared well, he could win. Anything can happen. Keith knocked out Forrest Griffin. Anything can happen.
Hey, Forrest Griffin just kind of messed up the master plan for Shogun. Will Jardine mess up the master plan for the December meeting between Liddell and Silva?
I honestly think that I'm a better boxer, and I honestly think that I'm a better complete MMA fighter.
What is he talking about?
He is a true warrior. Oh, big leg kick! That's it! Here he comes! Oh, beautiful right hand!
He's hurt! He's hurt badly! He is down! Chuck the Iceman Liddell is trying to finish the fight! That guy has dynamite in his hand!
I've seen his picture so much and heard his name so much every day. Oh, you're fighting Chuck. Oh, you're fighting the Iceman. It's like, I'm going to be so sick of him when I get in that ring. I'm going to want to take it to him pretty good.
He's hurt.
You know, it's the guy they put in front of me, and he's a tough guy, and we're going to go out there and have some fun, make it interesting.
It pisses me off that somebody wants to fight me and thinks that it's going to be a fun fight, because there's nothing fun about fighting me.
Big right hand by Keith Jardine. Jardine coming over the top. Oh, unbelievable. Keith Jardine has defeated Forrest Griffin.
Sometimes people feel like if they go out there feeling like they got nothing to lose, it'd be dangerous. dangerous thing.
I think he will be surprised when he fights me. In fact, I know he will.
If he stays standing, it's going to be an exciting fight until he falls down.
I wouldn't be surprised if it went down, too. Nobody's seen my jiu-jitsu, and no one's seen my wrestling, and it's a lot better than people think.
I'm not worried about the ground. I never am.
Look at Chuck Liddell!
Some main events, it's just people following a certain strategy and just trying to win the safe way, and you're not going to get that in this fight. You're going to get an actual fight, and I think the fans are going to get what they deserve.
It should be an exciting fight. I mean, both of us are going to be, swinging.
I'm here to get a fight. I'm going to win the fight. I'm going to break them, and I'm going to come out on top, and that's my game plan, and that's my goal.
I'm going to land some shots. I'm going to throw some shots. When I land them, he's going to go down. Absolutely.
Extreme Couture represented.
That's the new one. That's the one I like.
That's the one you like?
I like that one.
You mean one of the 400 that Affliction has made for you now?
This is a tremendous opportunity for Keith Jardine, but a tremendous amount of pressure as well. To go from a knockout loss to an unheralded fighter to jump straight into the main event against one of the most devastating knockout artists in the history of the sport. That's a huge leap. Keith Jardine's a tough guy. He loves to brawl. That's been his trademark. He loves to stand and bang with guys. And he is basically a tailor-made opponent to stand in front of Chuck Liddell tonight.
He spent some time in Montreal with George Rush St. Pierre preparing for this matchup against Liddell tonight. Of course, St. Pierre, prior to his last fight, went down to work out in Albuquerque, New Mexico with Greg Jackson. And the question, I think, in many's mind is, will Jardine look just to maybe pick Chuck apart? And can he be the quicker striker here tonight in the matchup?
I think that's the key for him. He's got to try and get off first. If you're going to beat Chuck, you have to keep him off balance. You can't let him keep his feet planted and settle into his rhythm and find his range. He's got to hunt him down, find angles, and the second Chuck stops moving his feet, you've got to hit him. That's the only way to keep Chuck off balance. If he gets into Chuck's rhythm, he's going to have a bad night.
Jardine said it will be an honor to fight Chuck. He's the greatest light heavyweight champion ever. He is excited to meet him tonight at UFC 76, and he too has predicted a knockout.
He's got great leg kicks. He's usually very durable. In the Houston Alexander fight, he was caught and stopped, but that could be because he underestimated Houston. He stood right in front of him, and also because Houston is an animal.
Well, speaking of leg kicks, that's something we haven't seen Liddell utilize in a while, and that's because he was in there with Randy, Jeremy Horn, Babalu, Tito, all guys in which Chuck wanted to avoid the takedown. Jardine may not look for that takedown, so perhaps Chuck will open up with some leg kicks as well.
It'll be interesting, especially if Jardine comes out and lands one of those leg kicks. And I felt those during the second season of The Ultimate Fighter. I got a chance to work out with these guys. He kicks very, very hard. He's a very, very powerful guy in the center of his body. It'll be interesting to see if him and Chuck start trading kicks.
He used those leg kicks to stop Kerry Shaw in a very entertaining heavyweight bout, which is the weight class that he initially fought at. Now he's down at 205.
Keith Jardine is set to face the former longtime champion. He's got that look in his eyes. This place is about to erupt. As the Iceman will enter the sold-out Honda Center here in Anaheim, California. And here he is, the former light heavyweight champion of the world.
According to everyone in his camp, this is a refocused Chuck Liddell. He's had a lot of distractions. It's well known that he lives what you would call the rock star lifestyle. He's a wildly famous, popular guy, and with that comes a lot of distractions. And that could have cost him in his fight with Rampage Jackson. Or it could be that Rampage has his number. We'll never know until we see these guys fight again. But what we do know is he's one of the most devastating knockout fighters in the history of the sport. His list of accomplishments is a who's who of MMA fighters. Knockout victories over so many great champions. He's got vicious power. He's got fantastic takedown defense. And he knows how to win.
Liddell has lost just two times in his last 14 fights. He had won seven straight and enjoyed four title defenses before he was defeated by Rampage at UFC 71. Now he knows that tonight is an opportunity to work his way back towards the light heavyweight championship. He also knows that with a win, he will finally meet Wanderlei Silva in December. Liddell has not gone the distance in a fight, Randy, in 5 years.
I don't expect that it's going to go the distance tonight. Somebody's going to sleep one way or the other. And that Wanderlei Silva fight's been highly anticipated for a long, long time. Obviously, when the Pride brand was strong and Wanderlei was unbeaten and the champion of that organization, and everybody wanted to see the two champions meet.
For this, the main event of the evening is brought to you by Knox CG3, the ultimate workout formula, powered by Zions, the former light heavyweight champion, 6 years older than the Dean of Mean, Keith Jardine. Everything else is basically identical. With the official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this UFC bout is sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission with Armando Garcia, Executive Officer, June Colasón, Chairman, and Mana Rodriguez, Commissioner in attendance. Event Supervisors Dean Lovis and Frank Munoz. Our judges at Octagon side for this contest are Cecil Peoples, Richard Bertrand, and Marcos Rosales. And when the action begins in the octagon, our referee is Big John McCarthy. This event is sponsored by Zenergy, the great-tasting ultra-premium energy drink, and Toyo Tires, the official tire of the UFC. Toyo Tires, driven to perform. And now, live from the sold-out Honda Center in Anaheim, California, it's time! Three rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 12 wins with 4 losses and 1 draw. He stands 6'2" tall, weighing in at 204.5 pounds. Fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, ladies and gentlemen, the Dean of Mean, Jardine. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 20 wins with 4 losses. He stands 6'2" tall, weighing in at 205.5 pounds. Fighting out of San Luis Obispo, California, ladies and gentlemen, he is the former UFC light
gave your instructions in your locker room. I want a clean, good, hard fight. Fight clean. Obey my commands. If I tell you to stop, I need you to stop. Got any questions from the red corner? Any questions from the blue corner? Touch gloves. Let's get it on.
Liddell Jardine tonight with a win. It's Liddell Silva in December. Big John McCarthy will get our main event started. Jardine against Liddell.
All right, here we go. You ready? You ready? Let's get on.
Non-title fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Let's watch for those leg kicks, guys, we talked about.
Jardine has such an awkward, herky-jerky style.
Good. There's the leg kick.
Very nice.
Nice right leg kick followed by a left hook that landed.
Jardine is extremely confident. The world may not think he can win, but Jardine thinks he can.
The more of those he lands, the more he's going to believe it.
Chuck loves when people come towards him.
Jardine's got a good game plan here so far.
Well, Chuck loves when guys chase him, guys. When he's backpedaling, he's the one man, well, one of the few men who can actually knock his opponent out.
He has great power when he's moving backwards. Jardine trying to land that right leg kick off him.
Again, body kick just fine by Jardine.
And Liddell is stalking him. Jardine.
Left hook.
Has a nod already.
Nice left hook by Chuck. Lead left hook. Look to him to follow with that right hand after that left hook.
Chuck's trying to load up that right hand, Randy.
He's really trying to range find here. Pinpoint his shots. Oh, right
Liddell
on the chin.
Chasing down Jardine.
Jardine.
Big welt on the right side of Jardine's eye with a little cut over his right eye as well. It's that left hook that keeps landing.
And Liddell wanted to fight like the next day, Randy, after he was defeated by Rampage.
Again with the left hook. Jardine's leaning right into it.
There's the blood starting to flow as you talked about, Randy. Combination finished with a kick again by Jardine.
Check that one.
Good that was to kick. The body.
He's had a couple of those guys.
Goes low, and then he comes high.
Looking at teep.
Chuck always keeps his hands so low. Looks like he should be able to hit him, but it's not that dang easy. Ask me how I know.
Yeah, I was. You know what? We were actually going to be nice to you for once. Ask me how you know once or twice.
Again with the leg kick by Jardine.
Yeah, he's finishing with that leg kick.
He's leaning into it. It looks like he's vulnerable to a right uppercut as he throws that right leg kick.
Blood coming out of the eye, and now the right hand is up by Jardine.
Jardine looks like he's a little more comfortable here. He's settled in.
Oh, straight jab by Chuck Liddell. Skipped off of Jardine's face.
Like we predicted, nobody thinking takedown yet.
Good right by Jardine, though.
The right was answered by the left. Started with Liddell. Liddell looks uppercut.
Keith Jardine is landing.
Both men have one punch or one strike knockout power.
Jardine looking at the clock there.
Chuck pushing forward again. There's the teep.
Got a poke in the eye, I think.
Chuck seems okay.
Little finger in the eye.
To teep that front kick, kind of a defensive mechanism utilized by Jardine a moment ago. He's wincing that eye again. 90 seconds remains in the round. See if Jardine utilizes that teep and then tries to push forward with an elbow. There's a kick from Liddell.
Jardine wisely gets out of there.
Chuck has incredible power in both legs. That's Babalu. And remember, 3 5-minute rounds, non-title fight. Vanderlei Silva, a very interested spectator here tonight. Will they finally collide in December, Liddell and Silva?
Starting to utilize a jab a little more as Chuck.
Jardine waves him in. Chuck with an uppercut again. Littell.
Right hand by Jardine.
Chuck's trying to time that little dip that Jardine does when he steps in and throws.
Caught him with a left. Over the top. Chuck loves to come over the top, Randy. Littell pushing in.
Good job of avoiding impact.
The smile on the face of Keith Jardine. We knew he'd be happy to go toe-to-toe.
Those leg kicks have got to be hurting Chuck a little bit. He's taken about five or six of those now.
And you talked about how hard those leg kicks are, Randy.
He kicks very hard. Look at his hips. Look at his center. He kicks very hard.
Good first round by both men. Willing to stand and exchange.
Let's take a look at that poke to the eye.
He reached out and put his left pinky right in Chuck's eye when he did the front kick.
And here's a Chuck Liddell right hand. Caught it right on the end of it.
Face to face, 1-2-10. You got it?
Okay, sure. Hey, Keith, gonna look for a head kick this round, so be careful. Deep breath, you're gonna hold it, baby.
Keith Jardine has got to feel a little bit more confident after that first round. He's got to think that he really does belong here. He did well. He landed a lot of good shots, especially leg kicks.
More importantly, he took some good shots, and he's still standing. He's still in the second round.
The beautiful Jamie Presley in attendance tonight, our main event of the evening. Second
round.
All right,
we go. You ready? You ready? Get
on. It's underway.
Jardine's corner looking for a 1-2-10. They want to see a 1-2 combination followed by a right leg kick. I want to continue that battering on that left leg of Chuck Liddell's.
He utilized that 1-2-10 effectively in the first round, didn't he, Randy?
He did. He didn't throw many 1-2s, but he landed a lot of 10s. Just missing with the left hook, Chuck Liddell.
Good jab.
Oh, good kick.
That's the third one that's Jardine landed right in that same spot.
Slapping body kick.
Randy, at this point in time, do you think Chuck is starting to get a little frustrated?
Jardine caught him big time. But Chuck is right back up.
Chuck pops right back up. He seemed to recover instantly. He was right back up.
He could still be hurt, though. That was a big right hand.
I'm not sure if he was just off balance or if he was really stunned.
It was a big impact. It sounded pretty hard.
Good body kick by Jardine.
Big welts on the left side of Chuck's body now. That's the third or fourth left
side. He swung another one.
Jardine seems to be gaining more and more confidence as this fight goes on.
There's a different look in Chuck's eyes right now.
He just got tagged, guys.
Another one.
Look at the welt on the side, the left side. You see it there. Of the midsection of Chuck Liddell.
Keith Jardine is starting to get really confident here.
Waving him in, saying, come on, let's go.
Chuck's great at countering, though. Jardine believes. And as Joe said, his confidence continues to soar.
Well, it's got to be flying high right now.
Look at
another right hand by Keith Jardine. He's ducking his head in. Avoiding Chuck's punches and landing his over the top.
Jardine's having a blast.
Keith Jardine is outscoring Chuck Liddell.
Oh, there's a big right hook coming out. Again with the right hand, Jardine lands it again.
Anybody in there know you can actually go to the ground in this sport?
I don't think you're going to see any of that tonight.
You got that right.
Look at the welt on Chuck's left side. Unbelievable.
What a battle.
Keith Jardine has such an awkward style, but it's very effective.
He's bleeding again.
Another leg kick, a good one.
That same spot.
Chuck's going to have a little trouble walking around tomorrow.
Have a little trouble breathing.
Another leg kick.
Got him in the leg again. Blood pouring out of the side.
It's not going into his eyes,
and
though.
And that's a great point, Joe. Both sides are bloodied up. Liddell tried to finish with a kick. What a battle in our main event tonight.
The side of Chuck Liddell is raw.
Jardine's a mess. He's got blood all the way to his belly button, coming out of both sides of his face.
That's a slip.
That was a slip, or if that was an actual shot that knocked him down.
Chuck swinging for the fences.
Knee. Look down with the knee.
Jardine hangs in there, though.
Oh, spinning back fist by Littell.
Reigns wasn't quite right on it. It missed, but interesting thing to think of right there.
Another leg kick. And a gun again.
Chuck's left leg has got to be really sore. You can see a little red poking down below the shorts.
Is Jardine starting to slow a bit, guys?
Well, he's exhausted. I mean, this is a pretty frantic pace.
Left hand at his waist, which isn't a good thing to have when you're fighting a guy with a right hand like Chuck Liddell's.
Chuck looks fresh still, though.
This is Chuck's game. This is what he trains for.
Body shot by Jardine to that area, and again with the leg kick.
Teeing off. Chuck is just...
Nobody looking to hit a single here. Everybody looking for the home run.
Yeah, you're not going to see a double or a single.
You got that right. Jardine Rose is nowhere to be found.
Jardine does look a little weary.
Another leg kick.
He does look a bit weary, doesn't he, Randy?
He seems to be staggering just a little. It seems like fatigue more than anything else, but he does have kind of a herky-jerky style.
And then again to that body.
That was all shin, too. Good impact.
Final 10 seconds of round number two. Jardine rocked Liddell in this round.
You got to give this round so far to keep Jardine.
Chuck's going to the wrong corner. Chuck's going to the wrong corner.
Wow. Let's take a look at that big right hand that Keith Jardine landed. Boom, on the jaw, drop Chuck. Chuck was in some deep trouble here.
Definitely hurt, folded up over that left leg.
And here's some of these body shots.
Man.
Over and over again, you'd see the raw damage on the side of Chuck Liddell.
Work the jab hard. Again, when he comes inside, shoulder close. That's the body, right? And then the outside, work the jab, forget the kick. When he comes in, let that left hook fly, and now let your punches come.
Now, if this was boxing, you would score that a 10-8 round.
Everything behind a hard left jab. Hey, breathe.
Long time trainer, John Hackerman. They've been together for over a decade.
So far, great performance by Keith Jardine.
I don't know that we expected anything less.
Step back.
Well, he's always been a fierce competitor.
Ready? Let's get it.
He's really risen to the occasion this evening.
Third and final round.
Another leg kick.
Huge leg kick.
Oh, man, that one sounded good. Left hook.
Oh, left hook landed.
Hackelman told Chuck to forget the leg kick answer.
Again with the leg kick.
Chuck hasn't checked either of the last two.
I'm sure he's having a little trouble picking
again
that up.
Again with the leg kick. And that's going to take a lot away from the power of his punches because he can't push off that leg the same way.
Certainly take the power off that left hook. He should drive that right hand should come from the other leg, but it definitely affects his mobility to establish an angle to land those shots. Oh, that was a big right hand.
Jardine looking for the upset.
A teep attempt again, front kick by Jardine.
Again with the leg kick.
Same spot every single time.
And he used that leg kick to stop Kerry Shaw.
And again, followed up with the left hook.
He's talking to him now.
Three and a half minutes remains.
Again. Body shot. The most significant damage of this fight has been landed by Keith Jardine over and over again.
His leg kicks and those body shots with that right leg have been devastating. He just continues to throw that.
Chuck's looking to time something, guys.
Well, he's trying, but it hasn't been successful so far for two and a half rounds.
Look how raw the foot and leg area of Jardine is from continuously punishing Liddell. Chuck ducks under.
Jardine doing a good job of moving away from him.
It's making Chuck miss a lot.
240 remains.
Again with the leg kick.
Man, those sounds
this time
terrible.
Chuck backs away from it. Checks that one.
But again, he falls under the left hook. Jam. Jardine's hands are low, guys.
Well, that could be because he's trying to goad Chuck into punching.
I wonder if Chuck feels like he's behind in this fight.
He can't feel good about it. Dropped, battered with leg kicks, battered with body kicks. Again with the body kick and the left hook.
We've got 2 minutes left in this fight, and Chuck Liddell needs to really mount an attack here to steal this third round.
And Keith Jardine's got to be careful he doesn't get caught.
You can make the argument Chuck won round one, and Jardine won round two. You can make that argument.
I would definitely give round two to Keith Jardine. Body kick again by Jardine. Minute 34 to go. Right hand by Keith Jardine.
Under 90 seconds now. Jardine looks fresher here in this third round. And he rocks Chuck again. Sweat goes flying. And again with the left hook.
Chuck just can't get off.
Every time he stops, he catches a right kick. And now he's following it with a nice left hook.
Good right hand to the body by Chuck.
Jardine's hand, his left hand is clear down on his thigh.
Watch your head.
Chuck working the body. 45 seconds remains.
A little blood trickling out
Superman
of
Superman punch missing.
The right side of Chuck's mouth now.
We might be 30 seconds away from Keith Jardine winning a decision over Chuck Liddell.
Chuck hasn't gone the distance in a fight in 5 years.
Right hand by Jardine.
Nice uppercut.
15 seconds remains.
Chuck's mouth is wide open.
High kick by Liddell. Final seconds.
Little trickle of blood off Chuck's right eye now as well.
This fight has gone the distance.
Chuck threw his arms up and the crowd started booing. Randy, how do you call it?
Wow, it's a tough one to call. I see it as Jardine winning the second and third round. Third round being very close, but Jardine still did the most effective striking.
I think the second round was big for Jardine. Rock Chuck dropped him. And I think I gave the third round to Jardine as well. First round to Chuck. I've got, you could conceivably call the second round a 10-8 round. I think Jardine just won a decision.
I agree with you.
Wow. Who would ever thought that?
Yeah, not me.
Keith Jardine did.
Randy, do you think this could be a case of Chuck going into a fight with no worries, no nervousness? I mean, I was on Pharrell's Serious Radio show this afternoon. Chuck came on, smiling and laughing. I even commented, can you believe that this is a guy who's going to engage in a cage fight in 6 hours? Well, he seems so relaxed.
He's always pretty relaxed.
I was going to say, he's always been
I don't know that he'd take Jardine. I don't know if Chuck would take him lightly. I don't see that. I think he trained hard for this. I think Jardine's the one here that stepped up. I think Chuck has confidence that he was going to go out here and be able to land the shot that was going to take Jardine out, especially after seeing what Houston Alexander did to him just a few months ago. So
Jardine certainly stepped up, and I think it'd be a travesty to see him lose a decision here. Now, I don't see how he could have lost that fight. I really don't.
You hate to leave a fight like that in the judges' hands, any fight, really, but I see it the same way. I think it's a 29-28.
Especially in this fight where there's no confusion as far as who dominated ground positions or submission attempts. This is an entirely a kickboxing match.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Cecil People scores the contest 29-28, Jardine. Marcos Rosales scores at 29-28, Liddell. And Richard Bertrand scores the contest 29-28 for the winner by split decision, the Dean of Mean, Keith Jardine.
He has done it. Jardine upsets Liddell. Joe.
First of all, my friend, I'm here with the winner, Keith Jardine. Keith, first of all, everyone counted you out in this fight. How good does it feel to walk away with the victory here tonight?
It feels great, man. It feels like I won the belt because Chuck is the greatest fighter in the history of the UFC, as far as I'm concerned. So I just want to thank him for stepping up. And also, Hard Nutrition, Hard Nutrition, Hard Nutrition, Hard Nutrition.
You landed some beautiful leg kicks, Keith, and that seemed to be a big part of the fight here. Talk us through the Mickey's replay.
Well, you know, yeah, overhand, Quentin hit him over time, he throws his jabs low, so I was working on that, of course. Kicking's my thing, you know, I knew he'd come out that right after my kick, but I was able to beat him with the hook before he got that right. But you know what, man? I gotta give it to him, man. I was seeing stars for that whole first round. I was like, wow, man, this guy, everything he blocked, if I block it, it hurts. Everything he hit touched me with hurt, man.
Well, congratulations on a tremendous victory. It's a huge feather in your cap. Congratulations. We look forward to seeing you again. Keith Jardine, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, Joe. Thanks to everybody that came down here for me. Thank you.
Randy, it's a huge upset.
Absolutely.
Keith Jardine has beaten Chuck the Iceman Liddell, UFC 77. Rich Franklin will take on Anderson Silva. Supervising producer Craig Borsari, director of production Tim O'Toole. Tonight's show produced by Bruce Connell and directed by Anthony Pasquale Giordano. Machida remains unbeaten. Fitch remains unbeaten inside the octagon. John Fitch finishes Diego Sanchez and wins by decision. The long-awaited arrival of Shogun was spoiled by the original Ultimate Fighter. Forrest Griffin was beaten, but in the end, never looked better. For my partners, Randy Couture, Joe Rogan, Mike Goldberg, saying so long. Congratulations to Jardine. We'll see you next month back inside the Octagon.